For the ones who work hard to ensure their crew can always go the extra mile, and the ones who get in early so everyone can go home on time, there's Grainger, offering professional-grade supplies backed by product experts so you can quickly and easily find what you need. Plus, you can count on access to a committed team ready to go the extra mile for you. Call, click Grainger.com, or just stop by. Grainger, for the ones who get it done.
Love the flexibility of working in all sorts of places? Well, working on the go seamlessly requires a strong network like T-Mobile. We have America's largest 5G network, so whether you're on a video call at the park or uploading large files at a coffee shop, we have the 5G speed you need. Whatever takes you on the go, T-Mobile's got you covered. Find out more at T-Mobile.com/network today.
Coverage not available in some areas. See 5G device coverage and access details at T-Mobile.com.
Places, please. The Daly Migs Show is on deck. Guitars plugged in. Drums ready to go. Chickens.
They're a clucking.
Other animals. And action.
This is the Daly Migs Show on The Rock with Taryn Daly and Steve Migs.
While listening to the Daly Migs Show, please refrain from any unnecessary finger gesturing.
99.9 KISW.
Rockaholics, thank you for capping off the work week with the Daly Migs Show. Good morning, Steve Migs.
Good morning, Taryn Daly.
Are you ready to let your freak flag fly today?
Oh, because it's Freaky Friday.
Because it's Freaky Friday, baby.
Man, I almost was late today. For the first time in God knows how long, I actually utilized the snooze button. Terrible idea.
So, how many times did you hit snooze?
I have no idea, but usually I wake up, it's very specific, but I have an alarm that goes off at 3:07 in the morning. And I didn't wake up until like 3:25. So I think I must have snoozed a few times.
Well, you still beat me here.
I got here at the same time. I have no idea how that happened.
Good for you.
Way more urgency.
Look at that.
Yes, I'm here.
Swift.
I'm awake and I'm ready to go.
Are you ready to inform these rockaholics?
Allegedly.
Let's do it.
Knowledge is power. So give us five-ish minutes and we'll give you some interesting stuff you can talk about at work. This is the Daly Migs Download.
A.K.A. the DMD.
Here's your daily dose of doings happening in the world.
And the DMD is brought to you by Palace Lawn. Hey, happy National Pizza Day.
Yes.
Makes sense that today is National Pizza Day, being that we're walking into a weekend where a lot of pizza is going to be consumed. It could be National Chicken Wings Day tomorrow. It could be National Dip Day on Sunday, because the Super Bowl, I don't know if you guys know this or not, but the Super Bowl is happening this weekend.
This Sunday?
This Sunday. Super Bowl Sunday is finally here. It's going to be the Chiefs taking on the San Francisco 49ers. And speaking of the 49ers, of course, everybody's talking about Travis Kelce. Oh, not 49ers. Speaking of the Kansas City Chiefs, everybody's talking about Travis Kelce and Taylor Swift. So much so, you know, they do all these press conferences where all the players are talking to the media, but also talking to really just an absurd amount of random people that maybe aren't necessarily media. They're comedians or this or that, and they're just going to ask some questions that are kind of out there. Speaking of which, we'll be talking to our friend Craig Gass, who's one of those random people that are hanging out during all the media opportunities that are happening over in Las Vegas. But during one of these news conferences, and we use news conference very lightly, Travis Kelce was being asked some questions, and somebody decided to put him to the test and see how well does he know his own girlfriend's music. And they were like, hey, can you finish the lyrics of certain Taylor Swift songs, which I thought was kind of funny. And one of them, of course, being the song that says, karma is the guy on the blank. Now, the original lyric, in case rockaholics, I'm assuming, don't know, the original lyric is, Sarah, do you know?
On the screen?
Yes, yes.
Yeah.
But apparently she changed it because it was about some actor that she was once dating. And it was like a nod and a shout out to that guy. But now she says Chiefs for the answer because she's hanging out with Travis Kelce.
So romantic.
Here's how that went. Oh, I gotta turn it up.
I was wondering if you can help me complete this lyric here. Karma is the guy on the
Chiefs, of course.
Boom! Nailed
it. That is so cute.
It would have been funny if he said the other version.
I like that she sang it, too.
Made it a little bit easier
for him. She was great. Yeah.
She also asked another one. He didn't have as much luck with this one.
Finishing. Coming straight.
What's the second question?
Do you know the answer there, Sarah?
Home to me.
Oh, my gosh. She does know that.
Home to Tay-Tay. Oh. Well, there is a very strange debate taking place in the state of Washington. Two clams are vying for the title of state clam.
Excuse me?
The choice is between, Steve Miggs, the Pacific Razor Clam, which is otherwise known as the Siliqua Petula, or the Gooey Duck.
I was going to say, aren't we just, we're Gooey Ducks.
I mean, isn't that the Evergreen State College mascot?
Is it?
I think it is the Gooey Ducks.
I need to see their merch.
It's awesome.
I can only imagine.
I think that's where our friend Kathy Faulkner's son goes.
The Gooey Ducks is the nickname?
The Gooey Ducks, yeah. Yes. So every year, this is why people are saying the razor clam should be the front runner. Every year, tens of thousands of people are known to go razor clamming, and it's part of what makes being a Pacific Northwesterner a Pacific Northwesterner.
This could quite possibly be the dumbest debate I've ever heard.
Well, Steve, you're going to have to wait a little while. The issue will probably not be resolved until 2025, and at that point, we will know who is the official state clam.
Well, we know who is the official MVP for the NFL. Yesterday was the 13th annual NFL Honors. Happened in Vegas. And who won the MVP? Well, here you go. Machine.
The 2023 AP Most Valuable Player presented by Invisalign is Lamar Jackson.
Oh. I want to thank my organization, you know, Baltimore Ravens for, you know, finally getting his deal done.
That was awesome. Remember last year they weren't even sure they were keeping him?
No, it was wild.
What a great season for him.
And this year was bananas.
And he had a lot of great things to say about his players, his teammates, and all the fans for the Ravens as well. So shout out to Lamar Jackson, MVP. Also, Offensive and Defensive Rookie of the Year award winners on the same team for the second time in the past couple years. This time around, it was a Houston Texans quarterback C.J. Stroud and defensive end Will Anderson Jr. They won the awards respectively. Christian McCaffrey, as much as we want to clown on the San Francisco 49ers being Seahawks fans, how could you not like this guy? He just seems like a really good dude. He had a great speech after he secured Offensive Player of the Year award, deservingly so. Also, Cleveland Browns pass rusher Myles Garrett, he was the Defensive Player of the Year. Coach of the Year went to Cleveland Browns head coach Kevin Stefanski. And then Comeback Player of the Year, you got to give a shout out to Joe Flacco for what he did with the Cleveland Browns.
Yes. There's a Seattle daycare teacher that was fired for giving infants melatonin, and this ended up leading to a CPS investigation.
Jeez.
The executive director of the school said it was an isolated incident, and they took immediate action when they found out what was going on. In the state of Washington, our law prohibits child care providers from giving sedatives to kids without a doctor's note. Makes sense.
It's good that we have laws for that.
So now there's a big licensing inspection in motion, and medical experts are warning about the dangers of melatonin. Apparently, there's been a significant increase in the use among children over the last decade.
Kraken, they're playing tomorrow. Finally back on the ice after a forever break. It seems like for the All-Star break, taking on Philadelphia Flyers. It's a big stretch. 12 games left before the NHL trade deadline. So, I mean, hopefully we don't lose some of those players that we all know and love. But they got to start winning some games. Otherwise, some changes definitely need to happen. As far as weather, 46 degrees, going to be cloudy. Thanks to SeattleBoatShow.com for giving us the Daily Migs download. And that's what's up.
Our buddy, comedian Craig Gass, is down in Vegas for the Super Bowl, and we are so excited to catch up with him at 6:20.
The Daily Migs Show.
Celebrate and save at Ashley's Anniversary Sale. With Hot Buys, your choice of colors starting at just $3.99. Ashley Sleep mattresses starting at $2.50. Plus, receive a free adjustable base with select mattress purchases. And shop top mattress brands like Stearns & Foster, Tempur-Pedic, Purple, and Beautyrest Black with 60-month special financing only at Ashley. Subject to credit approval, no minimum purchase required. Minimum monthly payment, down payment, tax, and delivery may be required. See store for details.
For the ones who work hard to ensure their crew can always go the extra mile. And the ones who get in early so everyone can go home on time. There's Grainger, offering professional-grade supplies backed by product experts so you can quickly and easily find what you need. Plus, you can count on access to a committed team ready to go the extra mile for you. Call, click Grainger.com, or just stop by. Grainger, for the ones who get it done.
Love the flexibility of working in all sorts of places? Well, working on the go seamlessly requires a strong network like T-Mobile. We have America's largest 5G network, so whether you're on a video call at the park or uploading large files at a coffee shop, we have the 5G speed you need. Whatever takes you on the go, T-Mobile's got you covered. Find out more at T-Mobile.com/network today.
Coverage not available in some areas. See 5G device coverage and access details at T-Mobile.com.
Rockaholics, only two more sleeps until Super Bowl Sunday.
This Sunday, Taryn, and we're very excited about the Super Bowl, of course, but I'm very excited to talk to our next guest because he's knee-deep in all the festivities. He goes there every year, and he always has great stories about his time in the week leading up to the Super Bowl. Please welcome to the show our good friend, comedian Craig Gass. Craig!
What is up, dude?
How are you, my friend?
I'm doing good. I mean, it's not fun to not have the Seahawks in the Super Bowl, but you know, it's a Super Bowl. It's fun.
We've had years of that now to get used to that, having the Seahawks in the Super
Bowl.
That's
true. By the way, I was in Indiana last week, and somebody said, oh, man, they saw I had a Seahawks hat on. And they go, you know who's from here is Rick Meyer. And I had to tell him, dude, Rick, the password to my email for years was Rick Meyer is frickin' killing me. That was the password to my email. And it wasn't frickin', by the way. It was,
While we're talking Seahawks real quick before we talk about the Super Bowl, how do you feel about the new coach? How are you feeling so far about what they've been doing in the offseason?
I am an eternal optimist, which is why Pete Carroll and Russell were perfect for my life, because they just believed, no matter how bad things were looking, they just believed that they could win. The Seahawks could be 0-10, and I'm that guy that would be like, okay, now hang on. It's not official. It's not official.
Right?
First of all, got to win every game. I'm telling you, statistically, this is still possible. Like, I am such an optimist that I think it can still happen. So I interviewed the Chiefs and the 49ers with Carrot Top, and we also had Bert Kreischer with us on Monday. And I'm putting that video out today. Oh, look. Joe Montana's walking right in front of me.
Dude, what? No. Go say hi to him. Go say hi to him.
You want,
this is
dude, I could get tackled. Hold on. Hold on.
Oh, my God.
Hold on. Here we go. Joe's taking a picture. Joe. KISW? That scared him away. I don't know what you guys did at KISW.
Apparently, he's not yet listened to the Daily Mix Show.
Who has ever been a dictatorian? You can't do that.
It's unacceptable. Man, up until today, I was a Joe Montana fan. Never again. Steve Young for life.
Just tell me how I can make this up to you. Tell me what kind of picture you want me to take of Joe Montana. I will take it in the next few minutes, send it over to you, and you can put it on your social media page.
Perfect.
And, dude, Carrot Top genuinely wanted to be a part of it. I kind of threw it at him like, hey, man, I'm going to do this thing with the 49ers and the Chiefs. Do you want to go? And he goes, oh, dude, I would totally do that. I would totally do that. And I was like, all right, yeah, I'll call you. And I didn't expect him to follow through. And he's like, yeah, what time? I got to perform at 8. So what time do you want me there? And he came down, and it's one of those moments where you're like, cool, I got Carrot Top with me. And everyone at the ESPN, the Jimmy Kimmel Show, everyone's like, dude, Carrot Top. And I go, I'm with him. Anybody? Nope. I'm with – no. You're like – Entertainment Tonight, they all grabbed Carrot Top, and nobody wants to talk to me. And dude, and it annoyed everyone, but I have footage, and I'm sending you the link today.
Okay.
I have footage of myself on the Jumbotron at the Super Bowl. The NFL wanted to talk to him on the Jumbotron, and I'm standing behind him. I keep walking into the shot, pointing at him and saying, I'm with him. I'm with him. And everybody at the NFL was like, get out of there. Get out of there. You're not looking at me. But, yeah, I took the risk, and I'm on the Jumbotron at the Super Bowl trying to fit in. So, yeah, it's awesome.
I know you're saying ESPN and all the other people were recognizing Carrot Top. What about the players? Were they geeking out that they saw Carrot Top talking to them?
Every player except for, and this is kind of ruining, where a lot of people were too young, I think, to know who Carrot Top was. Like, dude, even like Tech N9ne, the rapper, I go, you know who this is? And he thought that he was from the movie Pirates of the Caribbean.
No.
He goes, yeah, man, this is Jack Sparrow. Adam Schefter from the NFL. I go, Adam, you know everything about everything in the NFL. You know who this is, right? And he goes, absolutely, Wilma Flintstone. And then he walks away.
Oh,
yeah.
Brutal. I bet Carrot Top loved that.
He actually did, dude. That guy is so self-effacing. There was one guy from the Chiefs. I go, hey, man, welcome to Las Vegas. You know who this is, right? And he goes, oh, man, you got to help me. You got to help me. And Carrot Top said, dude, I'm singing the national anthem. And he goes, oh, my God, no way. And he got all excited. Yeah.
Reba. So, Craig, of all the folks I've come in, you know, to know over the years, you're one of the biggest sports fans of all time, and you don't ever miss a moment to be in the action of something like the Super Bowl. But I got to ask, who are you rooting for? I know you're a diehard Seahawks fan, so I feel like I know the right answer, but who are you rooting for?
You have to root against the 49ers. Anyone who's a Seahawks fan has to root against the 49ers. And some of the guys in the 49ers are like, George Kittle is a very likable guy.
Yep.
And you secretly wish that something could happen that could put Kittle in the Seahawks organization because he's such a great player and likable dude. Loves pro wrestling.
I know. He's always rocking wrestling shirts.
Yeah, he's such a fun guy, but it's got to be the Chiefs. And plus, secretly, I want insecure men to be mad on Sunday about Taylor Swift. I want conspiracies. I mean, dude, I'm hearing stuff from people that think that Taylor Swift is going to make a political announcement. Like, I don't even know QAnon people that could connect this crap. Like, how do you put that together? Like, this makes no sense.
Right.
How in your brain do you get that spun out that you think Taylor Swift has a massive announcement and this whole thing is rigged so that Taylor Swift could change the course of politics in this country? Like, dude, you're bananas if you're thinking that. So I get a kick out of the idea that people are going to be pissed just to see Taylor Swift for a few seconds.
It's insane how people lost their mind. Like, oh yeah, we showed up for 44 seconds during the game. I don't care. I don't need to see her in my football game. I'm like, okay, come on. Yeah.
I don't even consider myself a Swiftie, and I'd like to see her for more than 44 seconds.
Show her more.
Me too.
Yeah.
Me too. I'm down for that because you know what? Honestly, every Super Bowl Sunday, I want to watch the commercials along with the game. I'm down for the commercials, the pop culture aspect of it. I don't know. I'm just going to put this out there. If anyone there in the Pacific Northwest is coming out to Vegas this weekend, if you have me coming out, I'm hosting an event with Chris Kale from Five Finger Death Punch.
Yes.
And Earl Campbell, the professional. Well, actually, a bunch of
Ryan Leaf.
We're hosting this event called Sober Bowl. And it is a family event because there's going to be no alcohol. So you can actually bring your family and not have to worry about knuckleheads. And it's at the Clark County Amphitheater, 3,000-seat amphitheater. And we've got giant 60-foot Jumbotron screens. But before the game, starting at noon, we have all this entertainment going on. Chris Kale is going to perform. He's also going to do some stand-up with me where he just makes fun of me. And we have Huntley, who was the winner of The Voice last year. He's going to perform. And then we got all these NFL players coming out. It's put together by people in recovery, but the intention is to have a fun atmosphere that you can just bring your family to and not have to worry about dumb people.
Hey, Craig, yeah. we have to play a song real quick. Could you stick around? Because I did want to share one of my favorite stories about you and me and my wife when we went to the Super Bowl in Phoenix.
Oh, absolutely.
All right.
Absolutely.
We're going to take a quick break, but we're going to come back with Craig Gass and talk about the moment that my wife felt very awkward around myself and Craig Gass.
We're going to have more with Craig Gass, who is at the Super Bowl currently in Las Vegas after Rush.
The Daily Mix Show.
Rockaholics, we are so excited to be chatting with the wonderfully hilarious Craig Gass this morning. He is down in Las Vegas experiencing the Super Bowl up close and personal. And it's just an absolute pleasure to have you talking with boots on the ground about what's going on down there.
Yeah, it's pretty crazy out here. Just as a football fan, I like coming out to see the players. Occasionally, I've seen Russell out here. Occasionally, I've seen other Seahawks players walking around. But mostly, I'm here to create content with the players that are in the game and put out silly content, which is coming out today. I'm going to send you guys a link so you can post it, the stuff that I did with Carrot Top and Bert Kreischer.
What a crazy combo. You, Bert Kreischer, and Carrot Top going around talking to athletes during the Super Bowl. I mean, you can't ask for more hard-hitting journalism than that.
Yeah, you know what? You're already teasing where it goes. It goes really sideways, and it kind of loses its focus from football pretty quickly. So, yeah, you're already ahead of the curve on that one.
And people should follow you at Craig Gass Comedy on Instagram. Your stories you've been showing. I mean, you were at the Sphere checking out U2, which, I mean, that must have been pretty. What is it like inside the Sphere?
Well, it's incredible that the sound is so perfect. We ended up in the railing in the back corner behind the edge. So we're behind the band. Usually when you're behind the band, the sound is awful because the speakers are out front. But the Sphere has 160,000 speakers throughout the entire globe.
Wow.
All pointing inward. So the sound is perfect. And at one point last night, Bono just goes, "Hey, I want to talk about stand-up comedy." And my buddy Jason and I looked at each other and he goes, "There's a special comedian that's here tonight that I want to talk about." And we're like, "Wait, what?" And he goes, "Comedy is the greatest, most daring art imaginable because comedians are alone on stage. And I want to give a special shout out to a comedian who's here, who's celebrating his birthday. I want to say happy birthday to Chris Rock. And we're like, what? And then we looked up in a suite. I probably shouldn't say this out loud. This is really creepy, but I can send you this. I looked up and I filmed 10 seconds of Chris in the suite. And you can hear me going, oh, dude, there's Rock right there. Oh, dude, that's Adam Sandler. Oh, dude, that's Steven Spade. I'm a voyeur watching successful comedians have enjoy their lives in more expensive seats.
Craig, I'll be honest. When you said he was going to say all that, he's like, we have a special comic. I thought you were going to say, ladies and gentlemen, here's Carrot Top. And I was like, this is going to be the greatest way to come full circle to the entire time of you with Carrot Top.
I was going to say, he just continually just sandbags me. How much better his life is than mine,
Carrot Top flipping you off. He's like, ah.
Is Carrot Top still super ripped?
Oh, my God. That dude. What's crazy is, like, my friends and I were like, it was my first time introducing him to my buddies, and they're like, man, he's so nice. And they were asking me a million questions about Carrot Top, and one of them was like, dude, he makes a lot of money, right? And they were able to pull up this story that his last contract was for $8 million a year. And it's interesting because he buys these expensive clothes that make him look poor. You know, he wears these, like, these clothes are like super baggy and super, like, it's really weird. I mean, yeah, but yeah, he is rich, which is what makes it even more interesting that he's so nice.
Well, dude, I have to share. First of all, thank you for the incredible experience at the KISS concert. And it kind of does tie into what happened when we went to the Super Bowl weekend in Phoenix. But Craig is a man after my own heart in that, like, he hits me up and he's like, hey, as long as you're willing to be fluid, I think I found two seats on the floor at the KISS show that you could take over. But if someone shows up, of course, move and go somewhere else. And, dude, we got to sit the entire time in those seats, 10 rows back, to watch KISS in that final show here in Seattle. I can't thank you enough for that.
That was a blast. That was such a blast. Yeah.
But, see, that's one of my wife's biggest fears, is being somewhere that we're not supposed to be. So let's go back to Phoenix, Arizona, for the Super Bowl that the Seahawks didn't win. Craig was there. We hit him up, and we were all hanging out. Craig took us to a Phoenix Suns game, which was awesome. We met one of the dudes from Megadeth. That was really cool as well. We had an incredible time. And then you're like, hey, do you guys want to go to the Steven Tyler after party at some event where Steven Tyler's performing in front of like 200 people? I'm like,
yeah.
I was like, you know it. Of course I want to. He's like, cool. So we go there, and my wife does not like going anywhere where she's not supposed to be, and I had no idea either. As we walk up to the door, we had no tickets. Craig was just going to work his magic, and watching Craig work his magic was one of the coolest things to me because, dude, you are so fearless. You just go up there like, hey, I'm Craig Gass, and the guy's like, no, man, I'm not going to make it happy. Like, all right, and then I'm like, okay, well, we're not going in. And then you go around to the back, and you're like, I'm going to try this way, and they let us in. My wife is sweating bullets, like thinking we're going to get arrested because we just snuck into this Steven Tyler concert. And it was amazing, dude.
Last year, the Super Bowl was in Arizona, and I hated that my buddy said this. I have a buddy who does morning radio in Arizona, and he was saying on the air, hey, Craig Gass is in town, you know, which means we're going to sneak into everything. In fact, when Craig gets here, I'm going to tell him, I don't want to do anything that you have a ticket for. But if Craig says, hey, dude, on Sunday at the game, I have a ladder and I know this one entrance and we can get in. He goes, that's what I want to do. He goes, I want to have a Craig Gass experience. Really, anything is possible. You just have to figure out how to make anything possible. I just, you know, life is what you make it. And playing by the rules doesn't necessarily get you there, you know?
Oh, dude, I loved it. I loved every second of that experience. But it was so funny because Craig gets to say, he's like, okay, I got to go. I got other things going on. I'm like, all right, cool. As soon as you left, my wife's like, we need to leave. I'm like, what do you mean we need to leave? She's like she was so worried that like a security guard was going to point us out like as if we were like marked.
Like you don't have a wristband or you don't have a pass.
Right.
No stamp.
The anxiety was, it was through the roof.
If I see Joe Montana again, is there anything you want me to do there?
Tell him I think his wife's hot. Because she is.
Okay.
Craig Gass, thank you so much for joining the Daily Migs Show this morning. You can follow Craig on Instagram. It's Craig Gass with two S's, comedy. Craig Gass Comedy. Also, your website is getgass.com. Gass is with two S's.
And soberbowl.us for more information about the Sober Bowl.
Enjoy the Super Bowl, Craig. We love you.
All right, guys. Have fun. And congrats on the new show. I can't wait to see you guys.
Yeah, hey, we can't wait to see you too, man.
Thank you, buddy. I'll see you guys.
Well, how would you like a shot at beating Steve Rockaholics? If you think you're a brainiac, He is currently 36, 13, and 3 in 2024. 206-803-ROCK. We play Beat Migs at 6:50.
It's the Daily Migs Show, Loud and Local Band of the Week. Here's the host of Loud and Local, Kevin Deers.
This week's Daily Migs Loud and Local Band of the Week is a group of young kids from Tacoma, Washington, called the Rat Utopia Experiment. They're performing February 17th at the Mopop Sky Church for the Sound Off Music Showcase. This coming Sunday, they're releasing the new song, Cool Sunday Schizophrenia. You can hear it on Loud and Local this Sunday. Let's hear a little bit of that new song by the Rat Utopia Experiment.
Sunday nights from 8 to 10 p.m. on The Rock, 99.9 KISW.
You've probably heard about generative artificial intelligence, but are you vigilant to its exploitability? Generative AI is shaping society and transforming our daily lives. While we want to embrace the potential, we must also set the standards for responsible use and safeguard the future of our digital world. HackerOne employs over 750 active ethical hackers that specialize in prompt hacking and other AI security and testing. The creative approach taken by a diverse pool of ethical hackers is the best way to discover vulnerabilities. When launching new AI deployments, let HackerOne's AI red teaming address the novel challenges of AI safety and security for your business. AI innovation can only be effective if models are tested for safety and security issues that could cause harm. Make sure your AI models and deployments can't be tricked into providing information beyond their intended use, and that security flaws can't be exploited to access confidential data or systems with HackerOne. Learn more about our AI red teaming today at hackerone.com/AI.
For the ones who work hard to ensure their crew can always go the extra mile, and the ones who get in early, so everyone can go home on time. There's Grainger, offering professional-grade supplies backed by product experts so you can quickly and easily find what you need. Plus, you can count on access to a committed team ready to go the extra mile for you. Call, click Grainger.com, or just stop by. Grainger, for the ones who get it done.
Love the flexibility of working in all sorts of places? Well, working on the go seamlessly requires a strong network like T-Mobile. We have America's largest 5G network, so whether you're on a video call at the park or uploading large files at the coffee shop, we have the 5G speed you need. Whatever takes you on the go, T-Mobile's got you covered. Find out more at T-Mobile.com/network today.
Coverage not available in some areas. See 5G device coverage and access details at T-Mobile.com.
Is there anything more satisfying than finding something that perfectly lines up with your taste and checks all the boxes? Like getting the perfect fit with a suit from Indochino. Their suits are made to measure and totally customizable with endless options. From timeless classics to bold statements, you can express your style exactly how you want. Choose your own cut, fabric, lining, buttons, lapels, and more to create the suit of your dreams. All at a surprisingly affordable price. They also offer fully customizable blazers, pants, outerwear, women's wear, and more. Every Indochino piece is made to your exact measurements, and they make getting measured easy. Simply set up your measurement profile in less than 10 minutes. You can send your measurements online from the comfort of your home or make an appointment at one of our showrooms. Find the perfect fit with Indochino. Go to Indochino.com and use code PODCAST to get 10% off any purchase of $399 or more. That's 10% off with code PODCAST.
Look around. You can find cars like these on AutoTrader. Like that car riding right your tail. Or if you're tailgating right now, all those cars doubling as kitchens and living rooms are on AutoTrader too. Are you working out and listening to this ad at the same time? Well, multitasking pro, cars like the ones in the gym parking lot are for sale on AutoTrader. New cars, used cars, electric cars, maybe even flying cars. Okay, no flying cars, but as soon as they get invented, they'll be on AutoTrader. Just you wait. AutoTrader.
For the ones who work hard to ensure their crew can always go the extra mile, and the ones who get in early so everyone can go home on time, there's Grainger, offering professional-grade supplies backed by product experts so you can quickly and easily find what you need. Plus, you can count on access to a committed team ready to go the extra mile for you. Call, click Grainger.com, or just stop by. Grainger, for the ones who get it done.
The Daily Migs Show presents the most popular radio game on this side of the speaker. Let's play Beat Migs.
Beat Migs, don't be a loser. Beat Migs, you're a loser.
Who's ready to beat Migs? I know I sure am, because we made it. It's Friday.
I'm gonna jump, but I kind of have to pee.
Oh, and Steve's doing something.
I'm doing the Beavis and Butthead.
Is that what that is?
I don't know.
Well, you're not jumping. You're more trying to thrusting.
I got bad knees.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yes. All right, I'm into this dancing thing now, I have to say.
It really energizes me.
I never wanted to see that, though, Steve.
That's what energizes me, is the look on Sarah's face when I try and dance. As a dance student, she doesn't appreciate my skills.
I don't think she probably learned that dance in her school.
She must have slept in that day.
I'm going to, literally Google Beavis and Butthead and see if you did it right at all. Today we have Anthony from Lacey. Anthony, are you there?
Good morning, Sarah.
Good morning, Anthony.
Oh, hello there.
I am Sarah, your host, and it's time for you to get out of here, Steve. For those playing at home, Anthony has 60 seconds to answer 10 questions. You can pass all you want, but you only get 3 guesses per question. Are you ready?
I don't know. Some of these questions that you picked aren't that easy, Sarah.
I have faith in you, Anthony, all right? The word Tamagotchi is a combination of 2 words, friend and what popular breakfast food item?
Pancakes?
No.
Pass.
The San Francisco 49ers have won how many Super Bowls?
5.
Yes. What band had the early 2000s album titled By the Way?
Linkin Park?
No.
Metallica?
No.
Flash?
No. When it comes to the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, what color bandana does Donatello wear?
Red.
No.
Purple.
Yes. What Las Vegas hotel has used the slogan "just the right amount of wrong"?
Hilton?
No.
Not that.
What state has the most tornadoes on average?
Tennessee?
No.
Texas?
Yes. The first Lollapalooza happened in what early 90s year?
92?
No! Oh. So close. Anthony, you got 3 correct.
There were some toughies in there.
Yeah, would you have gotten about the same score?
I think I would have done a little bit better, but I don't think I'm feeling confident that I could beat Migs.
But you could beat Anthony.
I could beat Anthony.
What you're saying. Steve, are you ready?
Oh, yeah!
The word Tamagotchi is a combination of 2 words, friend and what popular breakfast food item?
Oh, egg.
Yes. The San Francisco 49ers have won how many Super Bowls?
4.
No.
5.
Yes. What band had the earliest 2000s album titled By the Way?
Is that the Red Hot Chili Peppers?
It is. Nice. When it comes to the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, what color bandana does Donatello wear?
Red.
No.
Purple.
Yes.
Nice.
What Las Vegas hotel has used the slogan, "just the right amount of wrong"?
Ooh. I'm going to go with the Hard Rock.
No.
The Bellagio?
No.
The Ramada Inn?
No. Which state has the most tornadoes on average?
Texas?
Yes. The first Lollapalooza happened in what early 90s year?
1991.
Correct. What is the name of the sea that lies between Europe and Africa?
The Caspian?
No.
The Dead?
No.
The Sea of Tranquility?
No. Who was the Greek god of the underworld?
Oh, Aquaman.
No.
Poseidon?
No. Just no. It doesn't matter, though, because you got 6 correct, which was double Anthony's score.
All
6-3.
Let's go.
Sorry,
Anthony.
You tried
care,
your
Anthony.
Best.
I liked Anthony's voice, though. That was sultry.
It was sexy.
It was. Is that his normal voice, or do you think he just woke up?
That was his beat mix voice.
Ooh, yeah. I'm so impressed that you seem to know that friend and egg are Tamagotchi.
Well, because it looks like an egg.
Oh, you genius man.
Wow. Thank you. Say it again for the people in the back.
Genius man.
I'm really shocked, actually.
That was a lucky guess, actually.
Does anyone know the Las Vegas hotel that uses the slogan, just the right amount of wrong? In my opinion, it's one of the most swanky, sexy hotels.
The Wynn or something?
No, it's the same name as a cocktail.
The Cosmopolitan.
Yes.
Oh.
Have you stayed there?
Absolutely. I stayed there for my Dirty 30. Oh. It cost me a fortune.
What are we talking? Like four figures?
Yes.
A night?
Yes.
What?
Excuse me?
That's a bougie party.
I have never paid that much for a hotel.
Well, there was...
I get mad when it's over $200, even though I know it's 2024 and everything's over $200 at a hotel. I'm like, back in my day, you could stay somewhere for a good $120.
Well, it was my 30, and there was like 12 of us, maybe. So it wasn't all out of my pocket.
Did you stay in 12. Like a suite?
Oh, yeah. Oh. It was a 3-bedroom suite. It could like sleep a bajillion people.
So 12 of you split the four
yes.
feet. Oh, okay.
Yes.
Why not then?
Pack them in like sardines, baby.
Oh, yeah. At that point, you're Vegas. Sleep in the bathtub. You know?
At hockey tournaments in Spokane, we would pack them in like sardines. And we were staying at like the Red Lion, which was like, you know, under a couple $100 a night. And there was 6 of us in one room.
I've stayed at that Red Lion. A little river out there.
It's nice.
It's lovely.
Yes.
Okay. I just want to let you know that the Mediterranean Sea actually lies between Europe and Africa. Mm. And the Greek god of the underworld, Hades.
Oh,
duh.
Not Aquaman.
I'm a dick.
And really quick, I went on YouTube and I found Beavis and Butthead dancing.
Oh, let me
and
see.
Come on. I'm clearly doing the Beavis and Butthead dance.
Actually, yeah, you really. It's just a little bit of hip, but a lot of fist, it looks like.
A lot of what?
I am the great Cornholio. I need Skippy for my bunghole.
Okay. We're going to score.
I'm going to have to practice that. Maybe not in front of you guys,
recognize.
Steve's got moves. Okay. Like Beavis and Butthead. Today is National Pizza Day.
Can you, like, shut up?
Today is National Pizza Day. And, of course, everyone loves to debate whether or not pineapple belongs there. Well, a well-known actor weighed in on this with a member of our show. We're going to tell you what this means after the Red Hot Chili Peppers.
The Daily Migs. The Daily Migs Show.
Today, Rockaholics, we celebrate National Pizza Day.
Perfect timing with the Super Bowl on Sunday. I think they time it that way. They know everybody's eating pizza at the Super Bowl. That's like a go-to.
Imagine how busy a delivery service of a pizza place is going to be this weekend.
All I remember is when I had a Super Bowl party many, many years, it was the year the Seahawks won the Super Bowl, and we got chicken wings from Buffalo Wild Wings. And I remember walking in there to pick them up, and it was just like the line was out the door, even though we set up an exact time where we wanted to pick it up, and I planned it ahead, thankfully. But even still, like, the national anthem was going when I was finally getting my chicken wings. I was so stressed out because I'm like, people are going to want their chicken wings, but this is how it was.
Chicken wings, very popular. Pizza, very popular this weekend. And on National Pizza Day, of course, there's that debate that we always bring up.
We just got a text from somebody saying 100% pineapple belongs on pizza.
I disagree.
Because you're a terrorist.
No, because I don't like pineapple.
Oh, I know. You, Danny, he's not here today. He's visiting his daughter. But Danny also is a big fan of no pineapple. Sarah, how do you feel about it? And you worked in the pizza industry.
Yes, and that was not even a topping, because that's a big no-no in Italy.
Gosh. Oh.
Well, we're not in Italy. We're in Seattle.
You're Sicilian, though.
It doesn't matter. One of my favorite types of pizza is Detroit style, which I'm sure would get me banned in my household, but that's just how it is. It's freaking amazing. And oddly enough, though, I love pineapple on pizza, but I only like it I don't like it when it's cooked into the pizza. It has to be put on afterwards, like a room temperature.
Okay.
It doesn't have to be cold.
Yeah, that makes sense.
But it's funny because a few years ago, I was trying to find the clip because I knew that today was National Pizza Day. And we interviewed many, many years ago, actually 2018, Billy Bob Thornton.
Oh, he's the best.
Well, and he was amazing. He was so much fun to talk to. And I read something before we had the interview that he used to work at a pizza place, Shakey's Pizza.
Oh.
So my dumbass is like, well, that's the hard-hitting question I need to ask him.
This is going to be probably the dumbest question anyone's ever asked you, Billy, and I hope you don't get annoyed by me, but I have to ask you.
It won't be.
Okay. So you mentioned how when you first moved to Hollywood, you started working at Shakey's Pizza. What's your take on pineapple on pizza? This is the big debate with everybody these days. You've worked in the pizza industry.
Oh, listen, first of all, that's not a dumb question at all. I get that question 100%, and it's so much better than things I've heard before. I'm not big on the pineapple and pizza thing. I like pizza from Shakey's, first of all. I really like it because it was always thin enough. Really good. But the pineapple on pizza, my problem with it was that the pineapple always made the dough wet underneath each piece of pineapple. I didn't mind the flavor. But you had to eat it right then. You couldn't take it home because by the time you get home, there's doughy spots all over the pizza because of the pineapple.
That was deep.
He really thought that out.
That was very deep.
That made my entire day. I was glowing for the rest of the day. I'm like, I asked a stupid question, and this guy gave a well thought out, heartfelt answer to that question. And I can't disagree with him. I don't like the pizza, the pineapple when it's cooked into the pizza.
Well, a lot of people do disagree. About pineapple being on pizza. There's a poll from 2023 that found five favorite toppings are pepperoni, sausage, extra cheese, mushrooms, and chicken. But pineapple comes in at number sixth for most popular.
See, I'd
toppings.
Bump it up to at least five because extra cheese, that doesn't count. That as doesn't a topping. Really count. That's just more cheese.
And they also say that our least favorite toppings by far are anchovies.
Yeah.
Jalapenos are a distant second, which I also disagree with. But pineapple is also on the least favorite toppings, comes in at number three.
Most polarizing topping of all time. How do you feel about crust?
Oh, that's a dog treat. I give it to my dogs. Come here, little baby.
You and Danny.
Sit.
All right, Sarah, once again, I'm going to go to you. And last time I regretted going to you, but...
It's whatever.
Oh, my gosh.
Wait, do you have a feeling about crust?
That to me is the reward at the end of eating pizza is the crust. That's like the best part of pizza.
That's literally the most boring part of the pizza. Yeah.
No, you finish the pizza and you're like, I now have the... I was the idiot in college. Granted, I was broke too. If my buddies didn't eat the crust, I would eat the crust.
That's so weird.
Why is it weird? It's not like I'm making out with them. It's not like we're doing Lady and the Tramp and I think, put it in your mouth, let me eat your crust.
Do you at least dip it in something?
My mouth?
You don't put like a little marinara dipski or garlic sauce or...
Oh, I'm not
sauce.
Opposed, but okay. I'm also completely fine with just having the crust as it is.
Mm. I mean, I like a breadstick better than a crust, but...
I'm starting to rethink this whole partnership.
Rockaholics, have you ever purchased something that your partner thought was completely ridiculous? We ask this because the fiance of a pro football player nearly dropped $2.5 million on something for his mom. You're going to hear what happened at 7:20.
The Daily Mix Show.
Love the flexibility of working in all sorts of places? Well, working on the go seamlessly requires a strong network like T-Mobile. We have America's largest 5G network, so whether you're on a video call at the park or uploading large files at a coffee shop, we have the 5G speed you need. Whatever takes you on the go, T-Mobile's got you covered. Find out more at T-Mobile.com/network today.
Coverage not available in some areas. See 5G device coverage and access details at T-Mobile.com.
Celebrate and save at Ashley's Anniversary Sale. With Hot Buys, your choice of colors starting at just $3.99. Ashley Sleep mattresses starting at $2.50. Plus, receive a free adjustable base with select mattress purchases. And shop top mattress brands like Stearns & Foster, Tempur-Pedic, Purple, and Beautyrest Black with 60-month special financing only at Ashley. Subject to credit approval, no minimum purchase required. Minimum monthly payment, down payment, tax, and delivery may be required. See store for details.
Look around. You can find cars like these on AutoTrader. New cars, used cars, electric cars, maybe even flying cars. Okay, no flying cars, but as soon as they get invented, they'll be on AutoTrader. Just you wait. AutoTrader.
Rockaholics, have you ever made a crazy purchase? One that maybe made your significant other look at you like you were absolutely crazy?
I mean, we're talking about in the past week, yes.
Or did your partner make a purchase that you thought was nuts? If so, we want to hear from you. 206-803-ROCK. The reason we're bringing this up, Steve Migs, is because this nearly happened to Christian McCaffrey of the 49ers leading up to this weekend's Super Bowl.
Man, I love this guy because I saw him yesterday. He accepted the award for best offensive player. Had a lot of love for his teammates. Just seems like an all-around good dude. And I did see that he was talking to some media, talking about I guess his fiance wanted to buy one of those suites that we've been talking about, $2.5 million suite. So that it's not even, I mean, of course, she's going to get to enjoy it as well. But it was more so for his mom for her birthday. That way she could go to the game with some friends and family and be in that suite.
That is a rad birthday gift.
That's a lot of money. Is it coming out of his pocket or hers? I know she was a former Miss Universe.
Yeah, so. She was at, like, Miss Rhode Island, Miss USA, Miss Universe. She's probably got her own things going on.
Shout out to Christian McCaffrey for that as well.
crushing it.
Well, one reporter did hit him up and put him on the spot about this attempted purchase. And it sounded like this.
Did she really get your mom a suite for the Super Bowl?
She tried to, but I will not let anybody pay to watch me play. I had to,
It's a lot of money.
She tried to, but I'm not letting anyone pay to watch me play.
So remind me again, when we talked to John Ryan, he was talking about you get like a certain number of available tickets, but you still have to pay for them.
You have to pay face value for the Super Bowl tickets. I think you get a couple free ones, and then you have to purchase all the other ones. I think you have the opportunity to purchase like 12 or 13 tickets.
So Christian McCaffrey is probably like, yeah, my mom can sit in the regular $10,000 seat rather than the $2.5 million luxury suite.
She can sit in the player section. It's going to be fine.
Rockaholics, have you ever made a purchase that was totally wild? Made your significant other go, what the heck were you thinking? 206-803-ROCK. Or maybe your significant other, your partner, made a purchase that you thought was nuts. Give us a call. 206-803-ROCK. We're going to take your calls after the Scorpions.
The Daily Migs Show.
206-803-ROCK. Have you ever made a purchase where your significant other looked at you like you were totally crazy for doing that? Or did your partner make that purchase that you thought was totally nuts? We'd love for you to call us up and tell us all about it, Rockaholics. 206-803-ROCK.
And we bring it all up because, well, Christian McCaffrey, his fiance dodged a bullet because she was about to drop $2.5 million on one of those suites at the Super Bowl. And his reaction was this.
Did she really get your mom a suite for the Super Bowl?
She tried to, but I will not let anybody pay to watch me play. I had to nix that. She tried to, but I'm not letting anyone pay to watch me play.
So mom gets to sit in a regular seat.
Right.
Super Bowl nosebleed.
What about all the family members? They're just like, dude, come on.
It's her birthday.
Let her get it for mom so we can go along too to celebrate mom's birthday too. One texter did text in at 206-803-ROCK. Something dumb I spent money on? A Honda Ruckus. Basically, it's a moped. My wife thought it was so dumb until she took it for a ride.
Mm.
Now we have two.
Oh, his and hers. That's so cute.
What do they look like, the Honda Ruckus?
I don't know.
I mean,
like a little moped.
A little moped. Yeah.
Sounds adorable.
What about you? Are you the one that makes the dumb purchases, or is it Brad, your husband?
I usually am the one that makes the dumb purchases. Everything from a sleep number bed. I mean, I don't really consider that dumb. It was just impulsive.
Did you run it by him, though?
No. And I bought an inflatable hot tub that I did not run by him. I once bought a fire pit.
Dude, I wanted to get one of those inflatable hot tubs. I made the mistake of running it by my wife. And she's like, absolutely not. You cannot. I should have just bought it. Our neighbor, you know, Dan and Sarah, they have one. And it looks awesome.
They're
and they use
cool.
it all the time. And the way that their house is, we're back to back. So I see that darn hot tub all the time.
Always like, just out enjoying it.
Right.
But my husband did do one time that I was like, bro. We got to have conversations about these things first. So he was hosting, he was emceeing, yes.
Because Brad seems like a rather simple needs kind of dude.
He doesn't ever, he never spends a lot of money. He would never think to buy a sleep number bed. You know, like he doesn't think about that kind of stuff.
I'm going to guess a very expensive acoustic guitar.
It is music related. But it wasn't an acoustic guitar.
A harp.
It was an autographed, framed Rush poster, which is still cool to me. It's obviously, like, I'm like, it's my favorite band. It's his favorite band. It's autographed by all three members.
Which you can't get now.
No, you cannot. And it's during the double neck guitar phase that Alex and Getty were doing. And it's just so cool. It's very, very sexy. But he was at an event where he was emceeing an auction, and he saw that one of the silent auction items was this Rush item, and so he did the first bid kind of just out of like respect for the band, you know, wanted to start the bidding and whatever. So as the silent auction continues, no one else is bidding on this thing, and I think the starting bid was like $300.
Okay.
And so he's now on the microphone saying, yeah, and over here there's this awesome Rush thing, if anyone else would like to bid on it besides me. Nobody else did, because, you know, there's only like 10 Rush fans in the world, and we're two of them.
He's so like, come he ended on, up just buying one person.
It. So he calls me, and he's like, he's supposed to be hosting this thing and, you know, getting paid to be there. Now he's just spending all the money he just got paid to be there on this Rush poster.
And that whoever hired him was just like, sucker, we don't have to pay for this guy now. He's paying us.
So he called me on the way home and was like, hey, I'm bringing something home from the auction. And yeah, it was $300.
See, my wife doesn't make a lot of purchases that make me roll my eyes, although she does have a gym membership. So she does CrossFit. She coaches CrossFit. So she's got a CrossFit, like, she's able to do that, which is awesome.
Mm-hmm.
But then she has a regular gym membership and she maybe goes once a month. And I'm like, you know, you could just like pay a couple bucks whenever you do go. Like, why are we paying a monthly membership fee? But she's like, well, just in case. I'm like, well, you get your CrossFit thing. You don't have to pay for that because you're coaching. So what am I going to? I'm not going to argue over it, but I always like whenever I see that bill, I'm just like, you know, this could be cut in half if we just ditched yours. But she always is rolling her eyes. I mean, just you name it. The goalie pads that I recently purchased apparently are showing up today. Finally.
Today. Can you wear them to work on Monday?
No. Somebody did text in at 206-803-ROCK. They said, I purchased a car yesterday. Yeah, my wife wasn't too pleased when I got home. She'll get over it, LOL.
I wonder what kind of car it is.
Oh, my new car, the Kia Sportage that I got at Kia of Puyallup. Shout out to those guys. I went there just to see what kind of cars they were going to have. But I left my house and my wife's like, you're not going to buy the car, right? I'm like, no, they don't have what I want, I'm sure. You know, it's like, you know, you heard those stories like, yeah, they got to order it. I had no idea if that's how it was anymore. I didn't realize that the people do now have cars on the lot. Like, I use that same argument that was happening when the world shut down. I'm like, I'm just going to talk to them and see what, like, the pricing is going to be like.
Yeah, doing your research.
Yeah, I'm just doing my due diligence. I'm actually doing a good job for a change. I'm not going to be impulsive. Fast forward, like, 2 hours later, I'm calling my wife, hey, babe, so they have the one that I want. She's like, you're going to buy it, aren't you? I'm like, yeah. She's like, I don't know. And then I try to explain to her all this. She's like, well, I guess. I'm like, cool, because I already signed the papers.
Did you tell her too? Free oil changes for life.
I did the math, and I got home with the car, and she's just like, I knew you were going to buy it. I know you too well. You're too impulsive. Like, you never go and do your quote-unquote due diligence. Like, once you want something, you will figure out a way to make it happen.
Do you get a free car wash there, too?
I do.
So the car basically is paying for itself at this point.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, you know, those car washes are really saving me so much money compared to the car payment.
I know that Sarah, your husband, recently purchased the, what do you call it, the Brandy Dragon from Costco. Have there been any other ones besides that?
I mean, he spends a lot of money on his hobbies, which change. He, you know, sometimes likes to paint, then he's a disc golfer, then he's this, that, and the other. But one time, an ex-boyfriend got me, like, a life-sized stuffed animal giraffe. Like, wow. Literally, like, 5'5", like, my height.
It's a life-size baby giraffe. I mean, a life-size actual giraffe would be bigger than your house.
Oh, yeah, that's true. That's true. Life-size... Life size, like, in my life.
I was like, wait a second. This thing is like 15 feet tall.
The size of a zoo animal?
Wait, okay, that would be cool then.
The head's popping out the window because you can't fit it in your own room.
Or it's just chilling in the backyard and my neighbors are like, what the hell is that?
So no. Are you a giraffe fan?
No. Oh. No. I don't know if you want to, I don't know.
Did, like, you ever say drunkenly, like, I wish I had a giraffe?
Literally never. He just randomly got it. And I don't know if he got it for me or himself, but I don't know if kids are supposed to ride it. I don't really have no idea what it was for. I ended up putting, like, jewelry over its neck.
Is that the price that he paid?
Yes.
I'm looking at the website, $250 for this thing.
That is a dumb purchase.
Right? Especially when I'm not a giraffe fan.
If it was, like, your favorite animal, I would be like, that's cute, but that's weird.
Single Steve would be really fired up to have that in my house, I tell you.
Do you still have it?
No, but I do kind of wish I did. I would bring it for you, Steve.
We're going to crowdfund one for Steve.
It would be so awesome to have it here in the studio. And then, like, anytime we have, like, videos, like, people are like, why is there a random stuffed giraffe in the background?
Why wouldn't there be a random stuffed giraffe in the background?
How about this one text, right? 206-803-ROCK just said, I once bought a car at a Black Friday sale without telling my wife. She woke up to the car in the driveway.
That's early.
That's amazing.
That is amazing. Rockaholics, have you ever had a ridiculous run-in with the law? One that you will never forget. Call us up now as we want to hear that story. Plus, it'll give you the chance to win Steel Panther tickets. Call us up, 206-803-ROCK. We'll take your calls at 7:50.
The Daily Mix Show. The Daily Migs Show.
Love the flexibility of working in all sorts of places? Well, working on the go seamlessly requires a strong network like T-Mobile. We have America's largest 5G network, so whether you're on a video call at the park or uploading large files at a coffee shop, we have the 5G speed you need. Whatever takes you on the go, T-Mobile's got you covered. Find out more at T-Mobile.com/network today.
Coverage not available in some areas. See 5G device coverage and access details at T-Mobile.com.
Celebrate and save at Ashley's Anniversary Sale. With Hot Buys, your choice of colors starting at just $3.99. Ashley Sleep mattresses starting at $2.50. Plus, receive a free adjustable base with select mattress purchases. And shop top mattress brands like Stearns & Foster, Tempur-Pedic, Purple, and Beautyrest Black with 60-month special financing only at Ashley. Subject to credit approval, no minimum purchase required. Minimum monthly payment, down payment, tax, and delivery may be required. See store for details.
You've probably heard about generative artificial intelligence, but are you vigilant to its exploitability? Generative AI is shaping society and transforming our daily lives. While we want to embrace the potential, we must also set the standards for responsible use and safeguard the future of our digital world. HackerOne employs over 750 active ethical hackers that specialize in prompt hacking and other AI security and testing. The creative approach taken by a diverse pool of ethical hackers is the best way to discover vulnerabilities. When launching new AI deployments, let HackerOne's AI red teaming address the novel challenges of AI safety and security for your business. AI innovation can only be effective if models are tested for safety and security issues that could cause harm. Make sure your AI models and deployments can't be tricked into providing information beyond their intended use, and that security flaws can't be exploited to access confidential data or systems with HackerOne. Learn more about our AI red teaming today at HackerOne.com/AI.
For the ones who work hard to ensure their crew can always go the extra mile, and the ones who get in early, so everyone can go home on time. There's Grainger, offering professional-grade supplies backed by product experts so you can quickly and easily find what you need. Plus, you can count on access to a committed team ready to go the extra mile for you. Call, clickgrainger.com, or just stop by. Grainger, for the ones who get it done.
Celebrate and save at Ashley's Anniversary Sale. With Hot Buys, your choice of colors starting at just $3.99. Ashley Sleep mattresses starting at $2.50. Plus, receive a free adjustable base with select mattress purchases. And shop top mattress brands like Stearns & Foster, Tempur-Pedic, Purple, and Beautyrest Black with 60-month special financing only at Ashley. Subject to credit approval, no minimum purchase required. Minimum monthly payment, down payment, tax, and delivery may be required. See store for details.
On the Daily Migs Show.
Damn. Some birds aren't meant to be caged. Yet, here we are, butt naked, eating soggy bologna sandwiches. Figure it's time to get busy living and get busy winning.
Let's play Cellmates.
Cellmates is the game where lawbreakers become game changers. And this week, we're playing for Steel Panther tickets. That show is happening at Showbox Soto on Saturday, April 27th. And I love a Saturday show.
The older you get, the better Saturday shows become.
Hallelujah. So let's meet our cellmates. We have Seth in Seattle. You got a ticket because someone, you, made an unsafe lane change. And they made you go to traffic school?
Yes.
First of all, what is traffic school?
I've been to traffic school.
It's so you can get the points off your record.
Yep.
Are you kidding me?
Yeah.
I've never even heard of this. I didn't know it was an option.
You could do it online. You don't actually go to a school where there's like a teacher and a chalkboard. But it's mind-numbingly boring too.
Well, how did this unsafe lane change take place? Was it on the freeway?
Yeah, I was on the freeway and I couldn't get past these people and. There was finally an opening and I made the move and a cop saw me, pulled me over and I was like, why did you pull me over? And he said, you made an unsafe lane change. And it was embarrassing because when I got to the school, everyone in the class was like, oh, I'm here for DUI. I'm here for red light running. And they get to me and I'm like, unsafe lane change. And everyone just like looked at me like I'm a dumbass, basically.
Nerd.
It's like a prison thing. They all just crowded around you and just beat you up. You're like, you're lame.
Yeah.
So the traffic school, do you have to, like, pass it? Do they, yeah? They ask you questions and you pass it?
Well, it was, like, an all-day thing, and you couldn't be late. Otherwise, it wouldn't count, and you had to stay in the class. There was no test. They just had to, like, listen all day. Mm. It was boring.
I would hope it's not one of those classroom settings where it's like the teacher says, does anyone have any questions? If not, you can go, and someone raises their hand with some stupid traffic
shut
question.
Shut up, Keith.
We're trying to get out of here.
Yeah. Dude, it happened. Mine was an online thing. It was back when I was living in Linwood, going to Puyallup to visit my now wife. And at driving so much, every once in a while I would dip a little bit too fast on the speed limit. Mm. Got a couple too many tickets. And then they're like, well, you know, you kind of bring these points down. If you take a defensive driving, or I can't remember what it was. It was some kind of driving online course, and it's like one of those things where you can't just skip it. Like, you had to, like, be there with the computer on, so that way you had to, like, hit a button so they knew you were
had to be interactive.
And it was hours, and it was mind-numbing.
So you and Seth, one of our cellmates, are both graduates of traffic school.
Both hard times.
Very,
hard times,
very
Seth.
Very impressive.
Hard times.
All right, Seth, we're going to meet your cellmate. It is Nathan in Seattle. And Nathan, I love this story. The cops came because you put a phone book in the oven and then forgot about it.
Yeah, really smart. How's it going, guys?
We're doing good. How are
so
you?
So good.
I'm pretty good. Life's good. Hey, Steve, I miss Bruiser Brody. I got to play with you guys years ago. That was an awesome band.
Oh, man, I appreciate that. I miss it as well.
Yeah, anyway, so my buddy Bastion and I, this is like in my first apartment, so I'll claim my ignorance by teenagehood. I was like 18. We're like, man, you know, I keep hearing you tear a phone book in half. I bet it'd be easy. We tried, of course, and it didn't work. But, like, I bet it'd be easier if we, like, tried it out. You know, some paper's really brittle.
Oh, my God.
And so we put it in the oven and forgot about it. We weren't even high or anything. I don't know.
Oh, that answers my question.
My friend called and was like, hey, you want to go see a movie? So we went to watch a movie, like, the whole thing. My phone's blowing up the whole time. I'm like, what's going on? I get out and listen to the message, and the landlord's like, there's smoke everywhere, and the police and the fire department here. It's like, oh, God. So we go back there, and they kick down the door. Everything turned out being okay, like the rest of the building didn't get some fire or anything. But they pull this charred log of a phone book out, and the cop's like, so why is there a phone book in the oven? And I had to come up with something because I can't say, hey, my buddy got to tear a phone book in half. So I came up with, we were trying to look up the movie times in the phone book, and I dropped it in the sink, so we were trying to dry it out. And that was also the wrong answer, but just slightly better, so that we weren't being carted away for, you know.
See, I think the real story is equally as dumb, but also I think if I was a cop, if I heard you say that, I'd be like, yeah, you know, I can understand the logic a little bit.
Also, Nathan, fast forward to 2024, have you ever successfully ripped a phone book in half? Did you ever achieve your dreams?
That's my goal for this year. The whole year was bad.
Well, the
training in the gym, take some physics, you know.
What's harder, ripping a phone book in half or just finding a phone book these days, though?
Yeah, well, that's what I was saying. It kind of dates me. I was like, I'm looking up a movie time in the phone book, so I don't think anybody's really doing that anymore.
But in all fairness, I remember when I was like a kid, you know, you're doing like taekwondo, and like one, in order to hit a certain like green belt or something like that, you had to break a wood board, and there was always that talk of you put the wood board in the oven for a little bit, warm it up so it can easily break.
Oh, see?
So yeah. You guys were going down the right path.
Like Darwin Awards were handing out here.
So maybe that's what I'm blaming him. It was his idea.
All right, Steve, based on the severity of the crimes of our two cellmates, who do you think should go first in the game? Seth or Nathan?
We got to go with Nathan. The story of putting your phone book in the oven and forget. And the fact that you weren't stoned, that makes it extra awesome.
I love it.
And not stupid. Time,
yeah. All right, Nathan, first question to you. Name the two performers at the center of one of the biggest controversies in Super Bowl history, the infamous wardrobe malfunction.
Oh, Justin Timberlake and Janet Jackson.
Boom.
I can't believe that was, what you said, 20 years ago that happened?
20 years ago this year.
Wow.
Seth, your question. Two teams are tied for losing the most Super Bowls with 5 apiece. Name one of those two teams.
It's going to be the Patriots.
Yep. All right,
what's
we
the
continue.
Other team? What's
the other
team?
One is the Broncos.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
All right, to Nathan, which country is the biggest exporter of coffee beans worldwide?
Ooh, Colombia.
No.
Oh.
It's Brazil.
Brazil.
All right. To Seth, if you get this right, you're going to Steel Panther. Who has won more Grammy Awards, U2 or Bruce Springsteen?
I'm going to go U2.
Yeah, baby! Seth is going to Steel Panther.
Congratulations, Seth. How many did they win?
U2 has won 22 Grammys, and Bruce Springsteen has a measly 20.
What? Let's go.
Yeah.
Congrats, Seth.
So excited for
Make
you,
sure
my
you,
man.
You, you, use your blinker when you're changing lanes.
Right.
All right. There is a survey out asking people what sex-related injuries they have suffered. And there are multiple on this list.
I haven't asked you yet, but I have a very strong feeling from some of the stories that you've been sharing on the air over the last month or so that you might have a story that goes along with this.
It's possible. What do you think came in at number one, Steve? I will tell you after Nirvana.
Yes, the Daily Migs Show.
Well, it should come as no shock that sometimes when people get down and dirty, they get a little hurty.
Down and dirty and getting hurty?
Yeah, and there's a survey talking about
it. Is this an Usher song?
Yes.
Okay.
Definitely going to be part of the halftime show. A survey asked people what sex-related injuries they have sustained.
Ooh.
Can you guess what is number one?
I mean, without getting too vulgar, I don't know, like a damaged dong?
That is on the list, but it's not in the top five. Number one...
I don't know how else to say it.
...is carpet burn.
Carpet burn? Yeah, I can understand that.
Yeah.
But I wouldn't even consider that like an... I wouldn't put that on like a level of like an injury, like a broken bone.
No.
Well, I guess some carpet burns are pretty bad.
Yeah, I mean, hopefully it's not a terrible abrasion. Number two on the list... Bruises.
Mm-hmm. Do I dare ask you? Because even some texters have even texted and saying, I'm learning a lot about Taryn Daly from some of these stories that she shares, and she sounds a lot more freakier than I realized. Shout out to Brad. I'm paraphrasing the texter, but he said something along those lines, and it cracked my ass up.
Well, number three on the list is one that I relate to.
Okay.
And recently.
Okay.
Pulled muscle.
I thought that was like the benefit of a, no. A pulled muscle. What did you pull?
Like
hamstring?
Like way deep in the groin area to the point where I almost drove myself to the emergency room the next day because I was in such pain and I was like limping around. I called my mom and my sister. I don't think I told them. I think I was like, I don't know what happened, but I got a little hurty when I got down and dirty. I didn't say that.
I was like, you told that to your mom?
But I was like, I don't know if I should go to the hospital. Like, anytime I stood up.
Just
and, like,
WebMD. They're
like,
always good.
Like, gravity would, like, take over and, like, blood is now, like, rushing to that area.
Did it
like,
happen while you guys were... Did I you have to stop the act?
No, I didn't realize it until after the fact. It was like...
Damn, Brad.
Yeah, right?
Brad's going in.
Number four on the list.
That sounded wrong.
Number four on the list is, I don't know if I'd really call it an injury, but a UTI.
What is a UTI?
Urinary tract infection.
Oh, okay.
Ladies, remember to go to the bathroom after you do the down and dirty.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
All right, do I dare ask now our friend Sarah over there? Because I think the only injury I've ever had was like, It was like a pulled muscle, kind of, I guess, goes to number three, like a sharp, like, neck back thing.
Oh, yeah.
And I turned a little too quick. I was like, whoa.
A little torque.
But I was just like, I'm not passing up this opportunity. Like, you know, it's like, I'm just going to work through the pain, rub some dirt on it, and keep going. But it was not pleasurable. Like, it was just like, oh, man.
Ow.
You know, like those stupid spasms that you get?
Yes.
Oh, that's the worst time ever to happen.
You know Sarah's got one. Has yours been mentioned on this list yet?
I mean, no.
Now, is it you or is it George?
Well,
have you injured George?
I
feel like you might have inadvertently, like, you know, broke his nose or something like that.
I very recently injured George. But I think it was a pulled muscle. But let me tell you, he had to call out of work because I injured him so bad. Yeah, I don't know what happened. I mean, it was kind of my fault. I mean, I think he was hurt before.
Oh.
And then... The lovemaking didn't help.
I think you called it lovemaking.
Yeah.
I'm sure that's what it was.
Yeah, I bashed my head, though, on a... you know how hotels sometimes they have, like, the mirror and, like, the ledge?
Oh, yeah.
The ledge, yeah.
Ow.
Where it's very, like, not placed well, in my opinion. But, yeah, I have...
I don't mean to picture you in that act, but I'm picturing you right now in that act, and I'm just... It's making me laugh. Like, just bonk, bonk.
Yes, that's exactly what happened. And I thought I was... I was killing it. And that really ruined the mood, let me tell you.
Just sucks the wind right out of your sails.
Someone texted and said, I did get my nose broken while in the act. My wife was getting a little too excited and inadvertently punched me in the face. There was blood all over the sheets, which were white. It was very embarrassing for both of us. We're still married, though.
Well, that actually, so number five on the list is a back injury, like you had kind of suffered, pulled muscle back injury. But then just outside of the top five was a wiener fracture, which is a real thing, I guess. And then a broken bone.
Broken bone.
You got broken noses.
Broken nose. Could you imagine that, like, your arms are flailing and you just like kind of cock someone in the face?
That's a great use of words.
I didn't mean it that way, but yes. No pun intended, but pun intended. Someone said, holy crap, is that why my wife goes to the bathroom?
Yes, absolutely.
The amount of UTIs I got back in high school was ridiculous.
Oh my God.
Well, I talked to my mom about it, and then she educated me.
Yeah, honestly, my mom didn't tell me, and I learned the hard way.
Right?
I did.
I had to drink so much cranberry juice.
I know!
That's a thing so to help, annoying. I guess.
If someone's drinking cranberry juice and it doesn't have vodka in it, you know why.
Literally.
There's no other reason to buy cranberry juice other than that and to mix it with vodka.
So if you see a lady drinking some cranberry juice, you go up to her and just like, how was your night last night?
Or no, you say, is there vodka in there?
Okay.
Okay, good. Well, a rockaholic DM'd us and shared how his Super Bowl party was so bad last year that his wife banned him from throwing another one. What happened? We're going to tell you at 8:20.
The Daily Mix Show!
For the ones who work hard to ensure their crew can always go the extra mile, and the ones who get in early so everyone can go home on time, there's Grainger, offering professional-grade supplies backed by product experts so you can quickly and easily find what you need. Plus, you can count on access to a committed team ready to go the extra mile for you. Call, clickgrainger.com, or just stop by. Grainger, for the ones who get it done.
Love the flexibility of working in all sorts of places? Well, working on the go seamlessly requires a strong network like T-Mobile. We have America's largest 5G network, so whether you're on a video call at the park or uploading large files at a coffee shop, we have the 5G speed you need. Whatever takes you on the go, T-Mobile's got you covered. Find out more at T-Mobile.com/network today.
Coverage not available in some areas. See 5G device coverage and access details at T-Mobile.com.
Celebrate and save at Ashley's Anniversary Sale. With Hot Buys, your choice of colors starting at just $3.99. Ashley Sleep Mattresses starting at $2.50. Plus, receive a free adjustable base with select mattress purchases. And shop top mattress brands like Stearns & Foster, Tempur-Pedic, Purple, and Beautyrest Black with 60-month special financing only at Ashley. Subject to credit approval, no minimum purchase required. Minimum monthly payment, down payment, tax, and delivery may be required. See store for details.
Rockaholics, if you have not yet followed us on social media, you should. It's a great way to keep in touch.
We have
our Facebook page is The Daily Migs Show. And then on Twitter and Instagram, we are at Daily Migs.
Let's not forget about TikTok.
Oh, yeah, we're ticking the talks.
We're trying to grow those followers. So if you're on TikTok, just find us at Daily Migs.
So we got a DM on our Facebook page from a guy named Kevin, and I'm kind of obsessed with it. He said, hey, guys, what's the craziest thing that ever happened to you at a Super Bowl party?
Okay.
I'm asking because my wife shot down me having a Super Bowl party this year because last year, one of my buds got so wasted that he went number one in our ice pellet machine.
Oh, my wife would. She would murder one of my friends if that happened. Those things aren't cheap.
Well, apparently, this friend bought them a new one, so he made good.
Okay.
But the wife is like, nah. And he also tore down the curtains while trying to stand up.
Well, that's fair. That happens to the best of us.
And Kevin wanted us to ask the Rockaholics about what's the craziest thing that ever happened to you at a Super Bowl party.
Wow. I've only thrown one Super Bowl party. And it was the year that the Seahawks won the Super Bowl. Maybe we need to have more Super Bowl parties. Maybe we're the reason why they don't win.
Oh, that's a good call.
Just kidding.
It's totally on our shoulders.
Honestly, I remember when we threw it, it was like one of those things where a bunch of us in the locker room, and our hockey team, were just like, where are we going to go for the Super Bowl? We got to watch it together because the Seahawks are going to be in it. And I was like, screw it. I'll check with the wife. I bet she'll be all right with that. And I go home and she's just like, you did what? You invited who? You know, because she loves my buddies, but she also gets
She has a lot of anxiety when anybody comes into her house. Children, adults, it doesn't matter.
Now, do the buddies come with wives and girlfriends, or is it just like it's a bro
day? No, okay. No. They wanted to, it's up to them. You can't come unless you bring your significant other. But no. Some of them brought, and there were some other people as well. And everything was going great until one of my buddies, and it's still, I don't think it was that big of a deal. He spilled his beer in the bathroom. And I'm like, of all places for him to spill the beer, if that's the only incident that we had at our house, I think we did okay.
That's the easiest place to clean up a mess.
Right. So, I mean, nobody urinated in a pellet ice machine. Oh, nobody ripped down any drapes. But yet, both of us are being punished and we can't have parties anymore.
And that was the first year we went
10 years ago.
Oh my God, that's bananas.
10 years ago.
So I don't remember who was playing, but at the time I was dating someone who, we were, you know where the Irishman is? In Everett.
Okay.
So we've been watching the Super Bowl at the Irishman.
I say, okay, I don't know where it is. Like, if you asked me to go find you at the Irishman, I'd be like, if I don't have GPS, you're screwed.
It's right around the corner from Angel of the Winds Arena. It's a great place to go before or after a show.
I know how to get there.
Yes.
Okay.
So we were at the Irishman watching the Super Bowl, and what ended up happening was a group of us went out literally into the street, which was not blocked off, and started throwing a football around. Well, my guy sprained his ankle so bad that we ended up having to make an emergency room trip.
And you didn't get to watch the rest of the game?
Didn't get to watch the rest of the game, which was super, it was a bummer. But we weren't playing in it, so that, I didn't really have a dog in the fight, I guess. But yeah, the Super Bowl party ended very quickly. So, Rockaholics, based on Kevin's message, who, by the way, said he loves the new show. Thank you, Kevin. We want to know from you, what is the craziest thing that ever happened to you at a Super Bowl party? Call us up now, 206-803-ROCK. We will take your calls after Sublime.
The Daily Migs Show.
Ahead of Super Bowl Sunday this weekend, we are asking you, Rockaholics, what is the craziest thing that ever happened to you at a Super Bowl party? Call in now, 206-803-ROCK. Tim in Squim, I like that rhymes, you went to a hotel to watch the game and your buddy threw up behind the projector screen.
That's correct. So this goes back to like the mid-80s. I was living in California. We were partying up really hard that day. It was a Super Bowl game. We decided to go to the Marriott Hotel. And they had projector screen TVs back then, so they're sitting on the floor, right? My buddy's probably around 6'1", so he's not a small guy by any means. And he gets up. He was kind of a lightweight. He gets up and is going to get sick. So instead of going to the bathroom, he was so drunk, he walks behind the projector screen TV that everybody's looking at and begins to get sick. And you could see him because he's got his hand on the top of the TV.
So, like, you see a silhouette of him?
Oh, you can see him completely. Like, not a silhouette. No, you see him. It's like one of those big...
Oh, I see what you mean.
Yeah, and like, there was no hide. He might as well have just stood in front of the TV. And he just... He let loose, and it was like the most disgusting thing. And like I said to Sarah earlier, I don't recall whether we got thrown out or not because we were just blasted.
Do you remember which game that was for, which Super Bowl?
It was the Niners and somebody else back in the Niner heyday when they were dominating for years. But, yeah, it was like mid-80s.
Damn. Okay.
So, obviously, you're watching the game. There's some volume happening. But was it audible? Was his vomiting audible, like over the top of the Super Bowl?
Well, everybody, it was loud as can be in the place, but as soon as he gets up, everybody was silent. So, yeah, you can hear him hurling the whole time.
You're like, that's not Joe Montana calling out plays. That's some good. No, yeah.
Definitely not.
Are you still friends with this person to this day?
I still am, yeah. We are still really close friends.
Do you guys reminisce about this every year over the Super Bowl?
Do you know that we have not brought that up for probably over 25 years?
This is the year.
Probably because I forgot about it until you guys had this little thing come up today.
Now you're celebrating the anniversary with all of us.
This is the year. You guys need to watch the Super Bowl together and be like, hey, dude, you remember about 20 years ago? And see what kind of reaction you get.
Yeah, I'd love to, but he's still back in sucky California.
Screw that guy.
He better not be rooting for the Niners.
I am rooting for the Niners.
Oh, no!
Come on, man.
We'll let it slide.
Honest with you, dude. I don't want... It pains me to see the Niners win because of the rivalry, but McCaffrey and
I know. Debo, I like George Kittle.
Kittle, Purdy. There are some really likable players on that team that I'd be like, it'd be kind of cool to see, especially McCaffrey. Like, it'd be cool to see that dude win a Super Bowl. I just wish it wasn't with the 49ers.
That's how I mean, I like individual players, but as a whole, it's hard to you know, support the organization.
It's not even about the 49ers. It's about the fans, because you know they're just going to not let. I mean, vice versa. I'm sure Seahawks fans are the same way, insufferable to 49ers fans. And I, but in a way, it's like, okay, they win the Super Bowl. Then okay, now Seahawks, you got to step it up. You got the new coach. You got the new. You got a whole bunch of things going on. Now we got a Super Bowl winner in our division. That I don't know, man. There's something about that too. I'm just trying to tell myself that to feel better if the 49ers end up winning the Super Bowl. We did get a few texts at 206-803-ROCK. We got some pros and some cons.
Ooh.
Oh, man. You know, I want to start with this one. This is a pretty good one. We had a killer party at my bud's place. That was until my dumbass buddy, it was his place. He got drunk and flirted with some chick while his girl was there. Ooh. She proceeded to rip the TV off the wall, kicked all of us out. We went to the nearby bar and laughed about how crazy that was. LOL. And yes, they are still together.
But who's the crazier one in that situation? Is he crazy for flirting at a party in front of his girl, or is she more crazy for ripping the TV out of the wall?
The answer is yes to both. Both are idiots, right?
But I'm glad they're living happily ever after.
I would never
Sounds
go.
Sounds like crazy meets crazy.
Do you try and be like, hey, we're trying it again, guys. We're having a Super Bowl party.
Oh, no.
It's time. It's only people who are in relationships.
Redo.
No single ladies are allowed.
Oh, my God.
Another person said the craziest thing was watching my brother and now ex-wife implode. She was a Broncos fan. He's a Seahawks fan. They both kept getting drunker. One got happier and the other got madder as the game went along. I'll give you one guess which one was which. Haha. And then they screamed at each other for most of the fourth quarter. Awkward.
Yikes.
So I don't know if that was the reason why they got divorced, or that was just like the start of
that was the
down. Or maybe that was the first time that people in their life finally got to see what they were like when they weren't around people on their best behavior.
I'm just feeling a little bit sad about their, you know, relationship. Just putting so much weight in a Super Bowl.
Here's a good one. This one has nothing to do with breakups or TVs being ripped off the wall. Text it in at 206-803-ROCK. And feel free to call us and share your Super Bowl stories, parties, horror stories, or positive stories. Someone said we had an epic Super Bowl party when the Seahawks won the Super Bowl. We had a surprise wedding and told our families that it was an engagement celebration dinner. We watched the first half of the Seahawks, the Super Bowl, at her parents' house in Kent. We then drove to Salties on Alki at halftime to completely empty streets. Turned the game on right at the end of halftime. About 10 minutes later, we had our ceremony, and after that, we watched the game with delicious dinner. And then after the game, we were treated to an amazing fireworks show across the bay on our wedding. It was pretty epic.
That's amazing. That's the kind of party I want to go to.
That is awesome.
My friends need to step it up on these weddings.
One that wasn't crazy, but it was like, it made me realize that maybe having a listener party when your favorite team is in the Super Bowl is not necessarily, not a bad thing, but it made it hard to enjoy the game. So, like, we just started at KSW the year that the Seahawks went to the Super Bowl. This was the year with Matt Hasselbeck. Yeah.
06.
When it took on the Pittsburgh Steelers, unfortunately. We all know how that game went. Mm. But, you know, you're all excited. We're at the Showbox. The place is packed. Seahawks fans. But everyone wants to talk. And that's not a bad thing. I'm not complaining. Obviously, it's awesome to get to talk to people. But when your favorite team's in the game, you kind of want to watch the game.
Well, considering how it played out,
yeah,
it's probably okay that you missed it.
Probably for the best that I just got drunk with listeners and didn't talk to any, didn't watch the game at all. But, you know, as the game's going on, I'm like, I have no idea. I'd see the score, and then people were bitching about a call. I'm like, I don't know what happened. I was too busy talking.
I was in college for that game, and speaking of epic Super Bowl parties, we created stadium seating kind of in like a living room with milk crates. We stacked up milk crates and then put couches up on them to like kind of stagger some, you know, almost like stadium seating. And we fit a lot of people in there, and it was awesome. I mean, the outcome, obviously, not so awesome.
That's some probably good point. The Rams, you know, they did win the Super Bowl recently too. So we do have a Super Bowl winner in our division. You're absolutely right. I think it's just that rivalry between the Seahawks and the 49ers that was happening, especially about 10 years ago.
Oh, yeah.
But someone said, best Super Bowl party I ever had. My buddy, he's got a couple dollars in his pocket. He hired a sushi chef. We were eating like champions the entire time.
Wow. I wonder what that costs. What do you think?
For a sushi dinner?
For a sushi dinner, personalized.
I'm thinking you're pushing at least $500.
That's kind of what I was thinking.
You think more?
I don't know. Maybe we should try it.
You're going to pay for it? Because I'm
paying
for it.
We'll make Ryan Castle pay for it.
Oh, if he's going to be a company
card?
It's
for a listener party.
Put it on the company card. What, the one that we're hoping to do at Chuck E. Cheese? We show up with a bunch of sushi?
Oh, my God. Could you even imagine? Hey, we know you serve pizza with a brand new recipe, but we're actually going to bring in a sushi chef instead.
Is it cool if we bring our own sushi chef? Kids love sushi.
Your kid likes sushi.
Yeah, but it's always funny when I say we go get sushi because there's always somebody that wants to, like, tell you what you're doing wrong as a parent. I can't believe you take your kid to get sushi with them raw fish. You know, it's not very safe. I'm like, my kid is not, it's having, her idea of sushi is it's avocado rolls. And honestly, her idea of sushi really is the edamame because she just loves edamame. She just loves eating those things.
Now I kind of want to have sushi during the Super Bowl this weekend. That's something I've never done. All these lists that we've been looking at of like popular Super Bowl foods and things like that, sushi's not on there.
You could get like I know Trappers does an awesome sushi platter for the Super Bowl. And it's pretty big and it's not like, obviously it's not cheap because it's sushi, but it's not $500.
It's a steal.
It's cheaper than that. Yeah,
I kind of like that idea. Maybe that's going to be my new Super Bowl party tradition for this year.
You do that or swing sushi by like, Super you know, QFC and just get some of those pre-made ones.
I don't know if I... Do you like those?
They're amazing.
Are they? I've never had that. I'm always worried about ones that come pre-packaged. Like, how long has it been in there?
Grocery store sushi is on another level now.
Really?
100%.
I don't think I've ever had it.
I haven't had it in a while because it has meat in it, so I'm not eating the meat. But the Louisiana roll that was at the QFC, which had, like, crawfish in it.
What?
It's one of the best sushi rolls I've ever had.
Well, that's my next question. Like, how long has the crawfish been in there?
That day. They have this.
It's fresh every day.
Well, I pretend that it is, at least in my head. I'm pretty sure it is. I mean, I never bothered to ask.
Can you give me the approximate day in which this crawfish was harvested from the water?
I feel like it's relatively. I mean, I've never gotten sick. I'm still alive.
That's good.
Yeah.
Good to see you.
Give it a try.
Rockaholics, how would you like to beat Steve? He is currently 13. No, sorry, 36, 13, and 3. There's a lot of 3s in there.
Yes, there is.
36, 13, and 3
might
in 2024.
Might be 37 now because I won earlier.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah,
we're doing a really bad job with our data in this place. 206-803-ROCK. We're going to play Beat Migs at 8:50.
The Daily Migs Show.
You've probably heard about generative artificial intelligence, but are you vigilant to its exploitability? Generative AI is shaping society and transforming our daily lives. While we want to embrace the potential, we must also set the standards for responsible use and safeguard the future of our digital world. HackerOne employs over 750 active ethical hackers that specialize in prompt hacking and other AI security and testing. The creative approach taken by a diverse pool of ethical hackers is the best way to discover vulnerabilities. When launching new AI deployments, let HackerOne's AI red teaming address the novel challenges of AI safety and security for your business. AI innovation can only be effective if models are tested for safety and security issues that could cause harm. Make sure your AI models and deployments can't be tricked into providing information beyond their intended use, and that security flaws can't be exploited to access confidential data or systems with HackerOne. Learn more about our AI red teaming today at hackerone.com/AI.
Love the flexibility of working in all sorts of places? Well, working on the go seamlessly requires a strong network like T-Mobile. We have America's largest 5G network, so whether you're on a video call at the park or uploading large files at a coffee shop, we have the 5G speed you need. Whatever takes you on the go, T-Mobile's got you covered. Find out more at T-Mobile.com/network today.
Coverage not available in some areas. See 5G device coverage and access details at T-Mobile.com.
Celebrate and save at Ashley's Anniversary Sale. With Hot Buys, your choice of colors starting at just $3.99. Ashley Sleep Mattresses starting at $2.50. Plus, receive a free adjustable base with select mattress purchases. And shop top mattress brands like Stearns & Foster, Tempur-Pedic, Purple, and Beautyrest Black with 60-month special financing only at Ashley. Subject to credit approval, no minimum purchase required. Minimum monthly payment, down payment, tax, and delivery may be required. See store for details.
Celebrate and save at Ashley's Anniversary Sale. With Hot Buys, your choice of colors starting at just $3.99. Ashley Sleep Mattresses starting at $2.50. Plus, receive a free adjustable base with select mattress purchases. And shop top mattress brands like Stearns & Foster, Tempur-Pedic, Purple, and Beautyrest Black with 60-month special financing only at Ashley. Subject to credit approval, no minimum purchase required. Minimum monthly payment, down payment, tax, and delivery may be required. See store for details.
Look around. You can find cars like these on AutoTrader. New cars, used cars, electric cars, maybe even flying cars. Okay, no flying cars, but as soon as they get invented, they'll be on AutoTrader. Just you wait. AutoTrader.
The Daily Migs Show presents the most popular radio game on this side of the speaker. Let's play Beat Migs.
Beat Migs, don't be a loser.
Ready to beat Migs? I know I sure am, because we made it. It's Friday.
Oh no.
Darren's doing it too. What is happening?
Fire.
Everyone is dancing but me. And it's such a scene.
Friday.
That's how you do it. That's how you celebrate a Friday around these parts, Sarah.
It really looks like something is wrong with both of you.
Speaking of pulled muscles doing weird things.
So what happened to Danny?
I may have re-injured myself.
We don't have Danny jumping, so we have to do the Beavis and Butthead.
Let's get to John from Seattle. John, are you there?
I'm here.
I'm Sarah, your host, and it's time for you to get out of here, Steve.
Real quick, you're blonde. I used to have brown hair. Beavis and Butthead. Is there anybody that could draw us as Beavis and Butthead?
Oh, I would love that.
Please do it.
Do you feel like you'd be a proper butthead?
Do I need to answer that question?
Could you do it? Could you do it justice? Representing.
Absolutely. I'll live the gimmick. We need Beavis and Butthead inspired shirts with you and me. Boom.
It's been put into the universe. It's being manifested.
Let's make it happen.
Steve, get out of here. Or Butthead, or whoever you are. For those playing at home, John has 60 seconds to answer 10 questions. You can pass all you want, but you only get 3 guesses per question. Are you ready?
Ready.
Which ex-NFL wide receiver launched a campaign to encourage excessive touchdown celebrations at the upcoming Super Bowl?
Trolls.
No.
Pass.
Which animated TV series follows the adventures of 4 boys living in Colorado?
South Park.
Yes. What was the title of Whitney Houston's 1992 hit from the movie The Bodyguard?
I Will Always Love You.
Yes. What Las Vegas hotel is shaped like a pyramid?
The Egyptian?
No.
Pass.
Slap, charm, and friendship are all types of what accessory?
Bracelet?
Yes. The Kansas City Chiefs have won how many Super Bowls?
Unfortunately, 2.
No.
1.
No.
3.
Yes. Jim Morrison was the lead singer of what band?
Doors.
Yes. Who voices Princess Fiona in the Shrek movies?
Cameron Diaz.
Yes. How many inches are in 4 feet?
48.
Yes. And with that, John, you got 7 correct.
That was a solid performance.
That's a great performance. Great. Oh, John, I really hope you win.
Let's go, John.
I feel like Steve has been on a winning streak, and I feel like we're all over it but him. Right?
Dude, I am the dark force to bring him down.
Yes, that's what I like
that.
To
that
hear.
That is the confidence we need this morning.
Steve, are you ready?
Yes.
Which ex-NFL wide receiver launched a campaign to encourage excessive touchdown celebrations at the upcoming Super Bowl?
Ooh, I'm going to go with Terrell Owens.
No.
I'll come back to that one. That's a weird question.
Which animated TV series follows the adventures of 4 boys living in Colorado?
Beavis and Butthead, no. South Park.
Yes. What was the title of Whitney Houston's 1992 hit from the movie The Bodyguard?
I Will Always Love You?
Yes.
And is it Greg Olson?
No. What Las Vegas hotel is shaped like a pyramid?
The Sphinx.
No.
The Pyramid.
No.
The Luxor.
Yes. Slap, charm, and friendship are all types of what accessory?
Bracelets.
Yes. The Kansas City Chiefs have won how many Super Bowls?
2.
No.
3.
Correct. Jim Morrison was the lead singer of what band?
The Doors.
Yes. Who voices Princess Fiona in the Shrek movies?
I'm going to go with Eddie Murphy.
No.
I don't know. Julia Louis-Dreyfus.
No.
Sarah McLachlan.
No. How many inches are in 4 feet?
Ah, crap. 48?
Yes. And with that, you get 7 correct, which is a tie.
Oh, son of a John, you did not beat me.
Okay, but you didn't lose either, so.
Was it Tariq Hill?
No.
Oh, man.
It was Chad Ochocinco.
Oh, that checks out.
Yes. My husband has been giving me a whole lesson on his touchdown celebrations. And so he launched a campaign so people would sign it so they could do whatever they wanted.
Oh, in my head, I thought you were trying, it was like to ban them. And I was like, oh, it'd be ironic. It was like Terrell Owens and I was like trying to think of someone who maybe is, but it's like Greg Olsen. He seems rather serious these days on the commentary, but he was a tight end. No. I was very confused by the question.
I was not confused by the question, but I didn't know the answer.
Oh, yeah. He has this music video out now and it's absolutely ridiculous. And George and I have been watching it every day after he gets home from work. It's like his hype up song.
I just live for a good touchdown celebration. And I love the choreographed ones.
Yeah, me too.
Like they've done like when they're like rowing or mm-hmm. all sorts of things.
For a while. Just
gather around the football and like pretend it's fire.
Or when they threw it like a bouquet at a wedding. That was great.
Or it's a grenade and they all fall over. Yeah, I love all those. The Seahawks for a while, like not recently so much, but like for a little bit, they had like very creative ones. Like Tyler Lockett seemed to be like the choreographer for
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's so good. I guess Chad used to do a lot back in the day and he did one river dancing or whatever, which was over the football.
Yeah.
I think they're
that too.
Yeah, I think they're so creative. I don't know why, you know, sometimes they don't let them do what they want to do. They made a touchdown.
Yep.
They made a touchdown.
They made sports.
Yeah, do a little dance in the end zone. You did get the Luxor. That's the Pyramid Hotel. And Princess Fiona's voiced by Cameron Diaz. That's one that John got that you didn't.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
You know which one? It wasn't a touchdown. It was Richard Sherman. It might have been a pick six. I can't remember. But, you know, obviously he's not a wide receiver. But he was celebrating. Remember when he celebrated with the Seagull?
Yes.
That was amazing.
Yeah.
That was like peak trolling Richard Sherman time.
Yes. Well, Rockaholics, we're wondering if you have ever been chased by an animal. We have a pretty crazy story about a guy that was chased by a moose. And you're going to hear what happened after Pearl Jam.
The Daily Migs Show.
Rockaholics, have you ever been chased by an animal? If so, you should give us a call and tell us all about it, 206-803-ROCK. The reason we are talking about this is because there was a group of skiers and snowboarders in Wyoming that got chased by a moose.
Moose.
Yeah.
Have you ever been chased by an animal?
I think I've chased more animals than have chased me.
We've done one of those things where you drive through an area with all those like bigger animals and we've seen like a moose. And being up close to one, that's the last thing I would want is to be chased by one.
I think I would rather be chased by a bear than a moose.
Really?
Yeah, moose are huge and terrifying.
Massive. But I guess I'm watching too many cartoons. I feel like a moose would be a little bit nicer than a bear.
Okay, now I want to know, because it says that a moose can run up to 35 miles an hour. Is a bear slower than that?
You're asking me? I have no idea. I know I'm slower than both of those. And that's really, at the end of the day, then I lose.
And with a moose, I feel like they tell you with bears, you're supposed to get big and try to like scare them back.
Right, right.
I don't think you want to do that with a moose.
No, no.
So here's a wildlife expert in Wyoming talking about this incident.
Usually moose are reacting defensively to the situation that they're in. It's not uncommon in areas where you have people recreating, especially even in big groups, in these areas that moose are spending the whole winter in and getting their food there.
No thanks.
I didn't even realize moose, so they don't have like a plural, it's just moose.
Moose.
So it's not like meese.
Meese.
Like mouse and mice.
Yeah. It's not. Well, I guess it's not meese.
Oh, look, we have somebody that actually has been chased by an animal.
We have an expert. It's Matthew in Woodinville.
Are they an expert?
Who has been chased by a Kodiak bear. I think that makes him an expert on bear chases.
Good morning.
Good morning, Matthew. How did this go down?
Well, I was cutting timber up there around Kodiak Island. And I shut my saw, and my partner that was up the hill from me, I could hear him screaming. And it finally dawned on me that he was screaming bear. So I looked kind of behind me over the bank, and there was a great big monster bear running straight up the hill at me.
So was he yelling at the bear to try and scare the bear off, or was he just yelling because he was scared of the bear?
No, he was trying to get me, my attention. He was probably 400 or 500 feet up the hill from me, maybe more.
So what did you do then?
I was running my saw, so I couldn't hear him or anything before that. So when I shut my saw off, he let me know there was a great big bear behind me.
It also surprises me that you were running a saw and that didn't scare the bear off or make you less desirable as prey.
Oh, you know that? Get big and act mean stuff? No.
Don't do
I
that.
I went right up the nearest tree I could find. And you never seen a human being climb a tree so fast.
Yeah, I would probably think the same way. Like, just get the hell away from this bear as quickly as possible. At any point, did it cross your mind that you had a weapon in your hand and maybe you could fight it off with a saw?
No, that saw, that bear, he wouldn't even cut through its fur.
Okay.
No, wait.
Bear would laugh at you and then smack the saw out of your hand and then eat you.
Okay, so we learned that a moose can run up to 35 miles an hour. Do you think that bear could have outrun a moose?
For a short distance, it'll keep up with it for that first 100 feet, 200 feet. You know, they can move. So I watched the thing as big as a Volkswagen move like a sprinter when he was coming up the mount, you know, the dirt at me, the hillside.
So running up
it was incredible how agile he was for being almost, you know, 1,500, 2,000. Because I've been face-to-face with moose, too.
Wow. And which one scared you more?
The bear. The moose was way bigger because he's all leg. It's like 7 feet of leg and then like a 1,000-pound body. And the moose is like, I don't know. So I grew up in Alaska, so I've seen a lot of animals. Hey, but the bear was by far scarier to me.
Matthew, going back to when you ran up the tree, what did the bear do then after you ran up the tree? Did it just kind of hang out? Did it look at you like, well, you silly human? Like, what happened?
No, he kept running. He wasn't necessarily chasing me. We probably scared him with the noise of our chainsaws. I was just in his path. He would have just probably ran right me over, you know, right over me. But I wasn't taking any chance of it. He was moving like a freight train.
It sounds like it was not the cocaine bear, because the cocaine bear does climb trees, if you've seen the movie.
No, even texters say bears do climb trees. You're very lucky to be alive.
No, brown bears don't. These are brownies. Black bears do. Kodiak bears, they're too big. They're 2,000 pounds.
Man, this is how I'd be screwed, because I don't think I'd be able to tell the difference between a black and
a
brown bear.
They push the trees over. They don't climb them. They push them over.
They're just like, I'm just going to get him out this way. Trees.
There are times where I'm like, oh, this shirt look good, and it's a black shirt. My wife's like, no, that's blue, dark blue. And so I'd be the idiot that gets murdered by a bear because I thought it was a brown bear, but it turned out it was a black bear.
Joe in Tacoma, you got chased by a horse.
Absolutely. So I was probably about 12 years old, and me and my buddy, his stepmom, trained horses, and we were in the arena with one of the horses exercising it by basically just running alongside of it. He was on the inside. I was on the outside, just, you know, kind of running with the horse. Well, the horse like freaked out and started like chasing me. So I am running as fast as I can, and this horse is like right on my butt. I mean, I could smell it. So I'm the outside and I'm just booking, and the railing, I had to jump up and, like, leap over the railing. And, you know, I'm 12 years old.
You're like a rodeo clown.
I got hoops. What's that?
Like a rodeo clown.
Absolutely, it was like a rodeo clown. But I was 12 years old and freaked out by a big old horse chasing me down.
I'm just shocked you didn't find out at the age of 12 that your destiny was to become a rodeo clown.
Right.
And that's what you're doing all these years later.
You missed your calling.
Yeah, I should have. Then I went to welding, and now I drive. So...
And you listen to the Daily Migs Show. Thank you, Joe.
Thank you, Joe. You rock. Dude, some of these texts are just insane. The people that are texting at 206-803-ROCK. I had a camel spider chase me in Afghanistan. It was about the size of my boot, and it chased after me after I threw a rock at it. True story.
I remember getting...
Those things are gnarly looking.
I remember getting, like, text messages, so, you know, when people have seen these in real life.
Yes.
And they are terrifying.
I mean,
that is what... nightmare is made of.
Looking at pictures gives me all... Another person says I was chased by a turkey. It was actually terrifying.
Some of those big birds can be scary. Geese can be scary. Turkeys can be scary.
Another texter shared that my dad's buddy back in the 80s was driving a logging truck, came across a moose, honked at it, and a couple hours later found the engine shoved into the cab from the moose ramming the truck.
What?
See, humans and moose, they don't like getting honked at.
They're very, very scary.
We didn't have a moment where we got chased by an animal recently, but it got a little scary for a second. We were taking Tatum to ballet class, and we get to the place, and there's this kid running towards our way, and we're like, why is he running? And we realize his dog is running at us, and his dog must have got loose, and it was like a pit bull. And we're just like, all right, the dog looked very friendly, but like all of a sudden this dog's running, and the kid's trying to hold it, but the dog is bigger than the kid. The kid's got no shoes on. He's in his socks. Like, it must have just run out of the house, and the kid went running after it. And he's, like, trying to keep this dog from getting towards us. You know, Tatum, of course, like, doggy, all excited. And I'm looking at my wife. I'm like, slowly walk into the ballet place. Like, keep going. I'll stay back here. And no, but Tatum wanted to play with it. And
dog was great. Dog licked her face, but I was just like, I don't want to risk this. Like, I finally looked at like Sid, and I'm like, just slowly walk. I'll play with the dog. And so I'm playing with the dog as Tatum's going in there. Of course, Tatum's like, I want to play with the doggy. I'm like, shut up. You get in there. No. I don't need this dog mauling your face or anything along those lines. Thankfully, we were able to get the dog back to the house. But at first, it was just like, this is a little gnarly. Thank God the dog was a happy-go-lucky dog.
But get your heart rate up a little bit.
With your kid.
For sure.
Yeah, even as an adult, I'd be a little, like, kind of jittery. But then all of a sudden, you have your four-year-old, and you're just like, I don't know this dog.
Put your body in between them.
And it could have been a pit bull. It could have been a poodle. I don't know this dog, and I'm a little scared about the situation because this could happen quick.
Oh, absolutely. Well, Rockaholics, if you consider yourself a massive fan of rock music, such a fan that you could name a song after only hearing 1 second of the chorus, we would ask for you to prove it. And if so, you could win concert tickets to see Beartooth. 206-803-ROCK. We're going to play Hook or Shook at 9:20.
The Daily Migs Show.
For the ones who work hard to ensure their crew can always go the extra mile, and the ones who get in early so everyone can go home on time, there's Grainger, offering professional-grade supplies backed by product experts so you can quickly and easily find what you need. Plus, you can count on access to a committed team ready to go the extra mile for you. Call, click Grainger.com, or just stop by. Grainger, for the ones who get it done.
Love the flexibility of working in all sorts of places? Well, working on the go seamlessly requires a strong network like T-Mobile. We have America's largest 5G network, so whether you're on a video call at the park or uploading large files at the coffee shop, we have the 5G speed you need. Whatever takes you on the go, T-Mobile's got you covered. Find out more at T-Mobile.com/network today.
Coverage not available in some areas. See 5G device coverage and access details at T-Mobile.com.
Celebrate and save at Ashley's Anniversary Sale. With Hot Buys, your choice of colors starting at just $3.99. Ashley Sleep Mattresses starting at $2.50. Plus, receive a free adjustable base with select mattress purchases. And shop top mattress brands like Stearns & Foster, Tempur-Pedic, Purple, and Beautyrest Black with 60-month special financing only at Ashley. Subject to credit approval, no minimum purchase required. Minimum monthly payment, down payment, tax, and delivery may be required. See store for details.
Daily Migs Show presents the Extreme Music Showdown. Let's play Hook or Shook. Please sign this waiver before we continue. Thank you. We'll drop a 1 second snippet of the hook of a song. If you can't name the song, watch out, you're gonna get shook.
It is time to play Hook or Shook, and this week we are playing for Beartooth tickets. You'll be able to check Beartooth out at the Showbox Soto on February 27th. Our contestant today is Cody. How you doing this morning, Cody?
Good. How are you doing?
So awesome, man. Are you ready for this awesome game?
Yes, we'll see. We'll see how it goes.
You got to get both songs right to win. The first one, you're on your own. The second one, a member of our show at random will have to get the song right for you. If you lose, caller 9 will get the tickets instead. So let's see who you are playing with. Will it be me, Migs, or Sarah?
Last time it was Sarah. Karen, Steve, is it going to let? And, stuck on Steve.
Yes!
It was so close to hitting Sarah.
It was a hair.
Literally.
Yes, a certain type of hair.
All right, are you ready for your first song, Cody?
Yes. Oh, no.
Would you like to hear it again?
Yes, please.
And let me know if you need a hint, because I can give you a hint.
Ooh, yes.
Should we play it one more time?
I might need one.
Okay, one more time. All right, here's your hint.
Oh, no. Oh, no. Don't even.
Dump button.
Female body part.
I don't know. I don't know.
You don't know? Ooh. Can I give one more hint?
Sure, I will allow it.
Okay, former president.
Ooh.
And I'm not allowed to give any hints. I'm not the one playing. Do you have any guess?
I can't land it.
We'll play it for you one more time, and if you can't get it, unfortunately, you will not win the tickets.
Sorry, Cody.
Is it the artist at least? Like the Pussycat Dolls? No.
No.
It's not the Puffy Cat Dolls.
Sorry, Cody.
Although I know what you're talking about.
I know.
It's Bush Glycerine.
I guess it's not a body part. It's more grooming.
Can't also a male have that?
Yeah.
In my experience?
No, you're right. I view that more as a forest.
A dense forest.
Look, it wasn't the best hint. That's why I came back with the former president.
Sometimes if you visit that forest, you need to be, you got to have a machete to get through. I'm sorry. Caller number nine. Caller number nine, 206-803-ROCK.
We tried.
You're going to get some tickets to see Beartooth at Showbox Soto on February 27th. Those are pretty decent clues there, Steve.
That would have triggered it for me.
Yeah, well, there you go. Rockaholics, if there's something that we have talked about this morning that you want to talk about, now would be a great time to give us a buzz. 206-803-ROCK. We're going to check in with the Rockaholics after Weezer. Throughout the morning, Rockaholics, we have received your phone calls and your texts, and we have not had a chance to chat with you until now. We want to talk to you, 206-803-ROCK.
And before we talk to, I know we have Seth on the phone. Yes. Before we get to him, I just want to give a super quick shout out to the man himself, this guy by the name of Wes, who created an incredible sign. I think you've seen it on our social media pages. A great sign that says The Daily Migs Show. And Wes, you're an awesome dude. I just want to say on the air, I know we said we gave you some love on social media, but that thing is so beyond cool. It's just 3-foot by 3-foot Daily Migs sign.
It's, yeah, it's massive. And then he made us four little mini ones to go with it, yes, that are kind of like coasters. And they're so cool, too. So shout out to Wes and the crew at Mines Mechanical. They gave me a whole tour of the place, and I got to see all these things they were working
on.
What
did they do there?
They make a lot of things out of metal. One thing they were making, it was human composting machines, or like the vessels for human composting, which is like a relatively new, like, afterlife care.
Well, I'm glad you made it out alive, because that sounds like the plot to like an awful horror film.
They're not like doing the human composting there, but they are building the vessels to send to other places. So it was pretty cool. Seth in Puyallup, you are the one that got chased by a camel spider, which is what my nightmare will be tonight.
Yeah, you know, chased is a strong word. You know, first of all, hey, thanks for having me on the show. This is so great. I love you guys.
Love you too.
You know, I grew up, my dad was an insect collector. So in my house growing up, you were taught to collect and catalog insects. These aren't scary things to me. So I was excited when the Air Force says, I'm going to send you to the desert because I want to check out one of these, you know, monstrous curiosities for myself. And the ones in Qatar are only about maybe 3 or 4 inches in length in their body. But God, they're so vicious looking and really just cool and scary. But they don't chase, actually. They don't like direct sunlight. So they chase your shadow. That's what we learned.
Oh.
They're chasing our shadow. So if we run, they're running right after us. They want to stay in the shadow because it's cool.
So they're just pacing with you, basically, then.
Yes, absolutely.
They're like, hey, can you quit moving, dude?
You know, I got cocky, and I thought, oh, I got to get a closer look at this guy. And I had gloves on, so I picked him up, and I'm showing him to my friends. I don't think it's a big deal, but I'm not paying attention. And then I feel this immense pressure on my finger. And what is happening? I look down, and he's got me. He's biting through my glove. And I can feel the pressure of his jaw. And, you know, it's not so much painful. I'm impressed at this point. I take my glove off. He actually drew blood on me. I couldn't believe it.
So is there any amount of, like, poison or venom that they have?
Yeah, what they do is they attach themselves to the underneath of a camel. And then they have this sort of numbing agent in their saliva where the camel can't tell he's being eaten.
What? Are you serious?
Okay, we were literally joking earlier.
They burrow a hole straight into their stomach.
So why didn't they call him Camel Killer Spider, at least as a heads up to the other camels?
We were joking.
So if I'm a camel, I'm thinking, oh, Camel Spider, come for a ride.
Well, we were joking that maybe they have humps or something. Like, maybe that's why they call it a camel spider, because it's got a hump.
No, that's what they do. They have a numbing agent, and it you know, renders their prey and able to understand that they're being eaten.
We need, like, Camel Spider-Man. You might be it, because you got bit by one, but, like the evil Spider-Man is Camel Spider-Man.
That's the new villain.
You know, they're so strong. Maybe I could use it. I don't know.
Well, right on, Seth. Appreciate the call.
Well, that is terrifying.
Now, all morning, after we talked about sushi, and you're like, I'm not getting sushi at a convenience store or a grocery store.
I'm just saying I haven't. I didn't realize it was such a thing.
Our text from people saying Winco, Costco, QFC makes it fresh just like you're at a restaurant. The sushi chefs are there. Taryn, you don't need to be worried. One person says QFC has great sushi. I work for a company that does the refrigeration work. It's prepared fresh every day, and they don't hold their seafood for more than 3 days. And then our friend Jason, who works with us.
Good morning.
He came in during the break to be like, no, man, I get that sushi all the time.
Yeah, there's the Safeway in West Seattle in Jefferson Park there. It's phenomenal. And I'm a big fan of the Costco sushi when they had it at 4th Avenue Costco.
That's newish now.
It's newish. It's been around for about a year. And I mean, I got addicted to it because I would go like every other weekend or every weekend to get, you know, supplies for us or whatever. And I saw this big case of sushi rolls. And I mean, I'm telling you, fresh and just fantastic. I have no other reason to shop anywhere else in my life other than Costco. Found it at the QFC. The QFC was amazing. But now because of that camel spider story, you know, they're spider rolls and they're delicious.
Yeah, don't get the camel spider roll.
I think that we want to avoid the camel spider roll.
Yeah.
I think. But,
so when you get sushi at a grocery store, do they have, you get all the things that go with it. They give you the soy sauce,
the wasabi,
everything.
The chopsticks, you get the
ginger.
The ginger. I mean, it's a full meal deal.
Okay.
And it's great.
I don't know when I get there early.
The selection's amazing, but every time I get there, it's usually like 4 o'clock on a Saturday, and it's like down to 4 things. I'm like, I'll take them. Let's go.
I don't know when it changed, but at some point, like overnight, it feels like they had their own little section with actual sushi chefs there. Like even the one at QFC, the one where I would get that Louisiana roll in Renton back when I was getting it, that one was incredible. I don't even know if they still make it, but the sushi chefs would even say, is there anything else you would like? Like they would make you something on order.
So do you know, I feel like sushi has become ever more popular in, you know, the last several decades. Do you think they're realizing this was like a great money-making opportunity? Like, is the sushi, in-store sushi,
my guess
ticket
is
a big one?
For my purposes, because I haven't seen any sushi chefs behind the counter making sushi where I go. But the fact that it's, you can take it and eat it, it's so quick, it's already prepared. Why not? And we live in the Pacific Northwest.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, we've got seafood all around us.
And it's reasonably priced.
It really is.
And sometimes they even have like good like discounts happening there. I mean, I don't know if we're part of like the sushi at grocery stores board that is trying to convince you to now try it. But you should try it.
I think I'm going to do it for Super Bowl.
I want to say like $8 or $9 for like 12 rolls at the QFC or at the Safeway.
12 pieces, not 12 rolls.
12 pieces,
that's
12
like,
pieces,
that's a
right.
Very good deal.
Right, 12 pieces. But I mean, it's great and it's filling and that's that's a crappy part about sushi is because you could eat so much of it, and by the time you finish eating all of it, you realize how stuffed you are.
Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm.
But when you're eating, it's like, it's going down like gumdrops. It's so good.
That's how I eat sushi, like a ravenous beast.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. You see me at All You Can Eat Sushi. I'm just like, yeah, this is a challenge.
You can't even get a word in.
I can eat. Right on, man. Yeah, thanks.
Yeah, you bet.
That's awesome.
So when you do get sushi, what is your favorite of the rolls?
Ooh. That's a tough one. I mean, because I love at Trappers. They have the Sounder roll. They have like a Mountain roll. Like I just like the ones that I used to like for a while. I was like all about like let me just get like kind of like simple ones. But I do like the Americanized versions of sushi rolls where they just like slop a bunch of crap on top of it.
Oh yeah.
So I don't really have a specific favorite. I just. If it's got a bunch of sauce, I'm all for it.
So like there's not a specific...
That creamy mayo
sauce
that they have. Oh, that's amazing.
I mean, I always tend to gravitate to ones that have eel or eel sauce.
See, I can't F with eel, and it's all psychological because I've had it once, and I thought it was really good. But just the idea that I'm eating an eel, I don't know why. Like, psychologically, I just can't get past that.
You know who I flipped to an eel eater?
The Ted Smith.
He was a very simple sushi eater.
He was an avocado roll.
He was an avocado roll dude. And then I was like, just try it.
He's like
and
my
then
kid.
He knew he had to make up for lost time and you know, catch up on all the opportunities he missed to eat eel on his sushi.
But I'm the same with like calamari when I used to have it. I would always be okay with the rings, and I know insert joke here what those rings are actually made of, but I couldn't handle The ones that had the little tentacles.
I will eat those. Give me all your tentacles.
And someone said, believe it or not, Safeway and Gig Harbor, the best sushi bar. And that's from William over at JBLM.
I'm a believer. I'm in. This is going to be my big plan on Sunday.
I mean, do it today. Why wait till Sunday?
That's actually a really good point. I'm going to pass many grocery stores on my pilgrimage north.
There you go.
Well, a man with a metal detector discovered a lost wedding ring and even tracked down the owner. But she said she didn't want it. Why? We're going to tell you at 9:50.
The Daily Mix Show. The Daily Mix Show.
Rockaholics, there is a man from Maine. His name is Scott.
Okay.
And he found a lost ring on the beach. I think he had like a metal detector of sorts.
He did, yes.
And then he ended up finding the owner through social media.
You gotta love social media for those reasons. Like the fact that people can track someone down for something as random as that.
Because almost everyone is on social media. So he found the owner. She apparently did not want it back.
Okay.
It was her ex-husband's ring that he must have tossed in the river.
Okay, random.
Yeah. And here is Scott talking about the ring.
Oh, we have issues with the audio right now.
Oh, hold on.
So I don't know if we're able to get the audio. I'll try and track down the audio, but I don't know if we're going to be able to because I'm the idiot.
No, you're not an idiot, Steve. You're just like us.
I'm so stupid.
We all have those days.
All right, we found the audio.
I'm like, you know what? I'm going to try to find the owner. So I dunked it in mineral oil, bought a magnifying glass. Well, I threw it on the buy swap, and this lady actually messaged me, and she's like, wait, I think that's my ring. I'm like, okay, give me the initials for the heck of it. 2 seconds later, she throws me initials. I go, when do you want to meet up? I'll return it. So then she finally tells me, she's like, well, it's my ex-husband's, and he tossed in the river, apparently. She was like, thank you for being a good Samaritan, trying to do the right thing. But honestly, you know, it's the ex-husband. She hates him. She's like, you can either toss it, keep it, or sell it.
I want to know what happened in that marriage.
I want to know if he's tossing it, keeping it, or selling it.
I mean, if she doesn't want it back, it's fair game. He can do with it what he wants.
Well, I would sell it.
For sure.
I'd definitely not toss it. I mean, either you keep it and you repurpose it for your own future. Wouldn't that be funny? Like, will you marry me? This ring is beautiful. Well, here's the backstory. Is that bad juju, though? Like, all of a sudden...
I don't know. What? No, your wedding ring, Steve.
Yes.
What is it?
It's the finest crafted rubber that you can get with that company, Qualo. Qalo.
Oh.
Do you know anything about these?
No.
You don't?
No.
They're like for people who you like, well, I think they're meant for like people like either like people who go to the gym or also people who work with their hands. That way you don't have to risk breaking your ring or hurting your hand or.
You do both of those
this
things.
It's just a rubber. It's just like basically a piece of rubber, and it's like $30. 20,
so was that the
bucks.
Ring that your wife put on your finger? Okay, so you
had no. We had I had a nice like tungsten or something like
yeah.
that. Like I love my ring, but also over time I've lost some weight, and my fingers have gotten less thick or girthy.
With two C's.
Yeah. So I remember one time I almost lost my ring. Stupid story. We were at a grocery store, and I pointed at the crab that was on sale. I'm like, look at the crab that's on sale, and my ring went flying. And it ended up in that giant, like, freezer where all, like, the fish and crab are. And I'm, like, pulling packages around. I was able to find it. But I was like, I need a new ring. And I'm not a ring guy, so I didn't want to spend a bunch of money on something like that was like, super expensive. And I love these rings. I've gone through so many of them. And they're great. Like, if, like, you have an issue with it, the sizing, they'll just send you a new one. Like, I've had a great experience with their customer service as well. And they have, like, different designs and styles. But, yeah, dude, like, $30-$40, I think, tops you're spending on one of these.
That's not too bad.
No, way better than dropping a couple $100 on a ring.
Well, and I'm wondering how much this one was worth. I need a follow-up to this story.
Here's my question. So she doesn't want that back. But is there anything that you have that you were in a relationship with somebody who now all of a sudden, like, you're no longer, like, I don't have an ex. And to this day, I still think about this Anthrax shirt that I let her wear. Like going to bed once, and now here we are. Like, dude, I should get over it. It's like over 20 years ago. I could probably find an Anthrax shirt, but I always think about that Anthrax shirt, and I'm like, I wish I would have got that before we broke up.
Do you think that now she has gotten rid of the Anthrax shirt, or do you think she still wears it to bed and thinks of you?
I don't know. Part of me's thinking like she's cleaned a few toilets with it and then moved on personally, but wouldn't that be weird if she still wore it?
Yeah.
Do you have anything that you wish you could get back from an ex?
I don't think I
have. Besides your time and money.
Yeah. I don't think I have anything on that list. I really don't.
Nothing?
No. And then my husband's wedding ring that I got him, remember, I've told our story how we found out we were getting married and we had 4 days to put it together. The ring that he wears was a $13 Amazon purchase. $13.
Yeah.
So if it got lost, I wouldn't be.
Does it make his finger green?
No, it's the weirdest thing. It's the weirdest thing. It's I don't know what it's made out of. And okay. I've asked him a million times, would you like to upgrade this? Should we get something a little more substantial? And mm-hmm. he's never doesn't want to. He likes that one because it's the one from our wedding day.
I'll be honest, I see, especially with dudes, obviously with women, like you see like these giant rings, you could be like, oh, that's a lot of money. Any guy that I see with a wedding band on, unless it's like got a bunch of diamonds on it, I have no idea what they're worth or not. You could be wearing a $5,000 ring, and in my eyes, it'd be like, I wouldn't notice it no different than a $13 Amazon special.
It's very fancy. He really likes it.
All right. Now, Sarah, is there anything that you wish you could get back from an ex?
It's kind of on the same lines as yours, but it's a sweatshirt. It was my favorite sweatshirt, and he knew it, and it was ragged. I'd worn it for years and years, but he intentionally didn't give it back.
He didn't give it back just to be a jerk.
Yeah.
But would he, was
Should
he
we go wear- track him down? Can we go knock on his door, like a whole team of us?
That would be amazing. I don't know where he's at now.
Would he wear the sweatshirt, or he just was like holding it hostage?
He was holding it hostage.
Oh.
Yeah. So that's even worse, I think.
Yeah.
It's not like he's using it.
No.
And now it's probably
he
like
just
burned.
Doesn't want you to have it.
Exactly.
Mm. Well, Pearl Jam is teasing a huge announcement soon, we hope. We're going to tell you all about it during the Daily Migs download after Joan Jett.
Knowledge is power. So give us five-ish minutes and we'll give you some interesting stuff you can talk about at work. This is the Daily Migs download,
aka the DMD.
Here's your daily dose of doings happening in the world.
And Ryan Castle is in studio with the Daily Migs show. It's wonderful to see you. Have you ever eaten sushi from a grocery store?
She's thinking the
sure.
same thing.
All the time.
It's so good.
All the time.
All right, I'm doing it this weekend.
Yeah, I do it all the time.
She's like, been opposed to it.
Like, I'm not opposed. I'm just nervous.
This is what I always say. It all comes out of the same ocean. Right?
Oh, I think you're talking about your bowel.
Yeah. Yes. It all ends up in the same place in the end. Ironically, which is the ocean.
I was like, is this some kind of euphemism for pooping? Yeah.
You know me so well.
I kind of do. It's delicious. Taryn, you got to try it this weekend.
I'm doing it.
All right. Hey, Pearl Jam. A lot of us fans are getting very, very excited because they just made an Instagram post to get us even more excited. The post just says, soon. And then there's a montage of tweets and social media messages from all of their fans saying, when are we getting some new music? I want some new music from the band. And while they're showing all those pictures, they have this music playing underneath it, which really isn't much, but it gets you kind of excited if you're a Pearl Jam fan.
I don't know anything about any of this.
I bet you don't.
I don't know anything about any of this.
Ryan is lying.
You have the song.
Again, you know me so well.
Do you have the song already? Somebody tackle him.
He's holding it in his heart.
Well, anyways, that's all we've got so far, so I've been listening to that on a loop because, you know, that's all I got. But it's so crazy. Somebody went to the, because they talked about how they had a big listening party for a bunch of friends, family, industry insiders, some reporters as well. Somebody went to that party uninvited, stood outside the door.
Oh, get out.
And filmed or recorded on their phone the bleed through the door, because it was like, I guess, rocking in there, and put it on social media. And Pearl Jam fans have been like listening to that. Like, I barely can hear it, but it sounds pretty awesome.
I've been to a few of those things. They usually make you sign an NDA. And I was actually invited to that one, but it was the same day of our 50th anniversary in Portland. So I had to be in Portland.
Missed it,
I didn't get to go. Yeah.
Well, Eddie Vedder recently did an article about him being interviewed about this album. He says, no hyperbole, I think this is our best work. Mike McCready has also said that this album is a lot heavier than you'd expect. So a lot of people do assume, and I think they're making it pretty obvious, that this announcement's going to be something about a song or a record or anything along those lines. But very exciting news for us Pearl Jam
fans. From what I've heard, strong agree with Ed, strong agree with Mike.
I'm fired up.
Let's go. Well, I just showed this video to Steve Migs. A bear attempted to break into a home in North Bend through their doggy door. And because everybody's got these cameras now, of course, it was caught on security cameras.
It's a big-ass bear.
Huge.
Bears tend to get that way.
The homeowner, but Amy Holt,
how big is
the
hole in their door?
It was like climbing all over their deck like it was nothing, like up on the railing and everything. It's wild. But they said that they don't really feel threatened by wildlife where they live, but they also stress the importance of bear safety practices, like securing your food and just avoiding encounters in general.
And not having a hole in your door.
Yeah.
Bear-sized hole in your door.
That too.
Also, the article has some advice on what to do if you handle if you come into contact with a bear,
you run.
Remain calm. Oh. Remain calm.
Depends on it. How many advice. People you're with. If you're with people you're faster than, run.
Yeah, and make noise if you don't like those people that are slower than you. Hey, this week, I don't know if you guys know, Ryan, I'm not sure if you're positive if you know this, but the Super Bowl is happening on Sunday.
Is that a marijuana thing?
Yes. Super. It involves the Chiefs and the 49ers smoking as much weed as humanly possible. Will the Chiefs go back-to-back? Will San Fran get with their sixth Lombardi trophy? Will Sarah pay attention to anything besides Usher? We just don't know, but we'll find out on Sunday. And last night was the 13th annual NFL Honors, where they gave awards like the Most Valuable Player, Comeback Player of the Year, and all that. And the big award winner was the MVP, and this is how it went.
The 2023 AP Most Valuable Player presented by Invisalign is Lamar Jackson.
I want to thank my organization, you know, Baltimore Ravens for, you know, finally getting his deal done.
I do love it. He gave a lot of love to the team and the players, but he did have to joke about the fact that there was a good chance they weren't even going to sign him last season because of, well, they wanted to move on, possibly, who knows, but had an MVP season, his second MVP, dang, which is very rare. He's only the 11th player in NFL history to win the award at least twice. And then the big scuttlebutt talk about yesterday was Comeback Player of the Year was Joe Flacco from the Cleveland Browns. Came off the couch, helped them go to the playoffs. But some people are like, how do you not give it to DeMar Hamlin from the Buffalo Bills? Well, dude, yeah, had a cardiac arrest during a game last season. Came back. Granted, he did not play a lot, 5 games, only 2 tackles. But, I mean, his heart stopped during a game, and he was able to come back and play the following season. That seems like a Comeback Player of the Year.
No kidding.
A lot of Ravens fans voting, apparently.
And the Kraken are playing tomorrow night. They're taking on the Philadelphia Flyers. So back after that long-ass All-Star break. So hopefully things turn around for them. Weather, we're going to hit a high of 46. It's going to be cloudy. Thanks to the SeattleBoatShow.com for giving us the Daily Migs download. And that's what's up.
Ryan Castle is up next with the Morning 12.
For the ones who work hard to ensure their crew can always go the extra mile. And the ones who get in early so everyone can go home on time. There's Grainger, offering professional-grade supplies backed by product experts so you can quickly and easily find what you need. Plus, you can count on access to a committed team ready to go the extra mile for you. Call, click Grainger.com, or just stop by. Grainger, for the ones who get it done.
Love the flexibility of working in all sorts of places? Well, working on the go seamlessly requires a strong network like T-Mobile. We have America's largest 5G network, so whether you're on a video call at the park or uploading large files at a coffee shop, we have the 5G speed you need. Whatever takes you on the go, T-Mobile's got you covered. Find out more at T-Mobile.com/network today.
Coverage not available in some areas. See 5G device coverage and access details at T-Mobile.com.
You've probably heard about generative artificial intelligence, but are you vigilant to its exploitability? Generative AI is shaping society and transforming our daily lives. While we want to embrace the potential, we must also set the standards for responsible use and safeguard the future of our digital world. HackerOne employs over 750 active ethical hackers that specialize in prompt hacking and other AI security and testing. The creative approach taken by a diverse pool of ethical hackers is the best way to discover vulnerabilities. When launching new AI deployments, let HackerOne's AI red teaming address the novel challenges of AI safety and security for your business. AI innovation can only be effective if models are tested for safety and security issues that could cause harm. Make sure your AI models and deployments can't be tricked into providing information beyond their intended use, and that security flaws can't be exploited to access confidential data or systems with HackerOne. Learn more about our AI red teaming today at HackerOne.com/AI.
UW Medicine is the only health system in Washington where a top-rated medical school and a research powerhouse are directly connected to improve your health. That means the doctors caring for you are the same people advancing medical research and teaching the next generation of outstanding physicians. From wellness checks to complex surgeries, we're committed to providing you with the best care every day. UW Medicine, a higher degree of healthcare.